there, guys. Welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's 11:02 hours on Friday, September 26, 2014. Loading up the truck. You excited, sir?
Totally.
Yeah. So this is all high plastic content e-waste that's been in surplus for over a year. And we have no use for, and nobody wants to buy it, so we're recycling it. We're not even, like, making any money on it, because it costs us money to recycle, which sucks. Like, some computer stuff we actually get a couple pennies a pound for, but all the plastic shit, it's just shit. Thankfully, they at least don't charge us to take it, but we have to spend money on fuel and all that jazz. Plus it wastes valuable Batman mad forklift skills time. Oh, what moves he has. This man can't be beaten.
Wow, such forklift.
He's got more moves than X-Lax. Look at that.
90s cult, they want their sayings back.
With grace and dexterity, dude. That's so, so much further back than the 90s. You don't know. So much further back than the 90s. In fact, there's your challenge today. The first person to comment with the correct answer to where that saying comes from, got more moves than X-Lax, can win a set of Bolt Depot thread gauges, because that's going way back. It ain't the 90s.
I know it's not the 90s, but
do you know what it's from?
I kind of remember.
I'll bet you don't.
Picture.
I'll bet
there's
you don't.
There's a lot of people who have used it, and that's all I keep seeing are the other people. I know.
I've only heard one other person use it in my life, because it's kind of obscure, at least by today's standards. When I was a kid, it was definitely... Where it came from would not be considered obscure. Hey, Batman. Batman.
What?
The side's open on that Gaylord.
You should flip it up for me.
Okay.
Even though it won't really matter.
Hey, Batman. Hang on, hey, God, back up, God damn it.
No.
Back the fuck up. Back, no, I gotta flip this up.
I'm not worried.
I gotta, it's not flipped up.
I'm not worried.
It's, but the thing. Batman!
Stuff isn't light,
it's not, like it's not flipped up. It's down. It's over. It's only half erect.
Game over.
Now that's not obscure. You know what that's from?
Yeah, that was God damn it.
Yeah, see?
It was,
oh, you're fucked now. The whole internet's watching you twist. Cause you tried it. You tried to bring it.
Sucked.
You tried to bring it and you can't. Ah! Fuck you! I got it! Oh shit! Huh?
Is it Alien or Terminator? The weird 90s sci-fi, 80s sci-fi.
I think you're wrong on both of those, actually.
No.
You're almost right.
Or it's Predator. Something.
No, it's not Predator.
God damn it. Me and references this morning are completely off.
It's not Alien. It's Aliens.
Alien.
Yeah. I think. I think it was the second one. I think it was from Aliens. I could be wrong though. I could have that totally wrong, but I think it was the second one.
I've been binge watching Watch Mojo. Have you seen WatchMojo.com?
A little bit. They do like the top 10 bullshit. Yeah.
Yeah, and I absolutely.
It's like short attention span movie night.
Exactly.
Oh God. All right, I'm holding this.
I'm not worried about it. That's why I'm putting it up against the other one, so that.
Yeah, but if I let go, it'll flip down. You're gonna hit the thing. You're hitting the thing. You're hitting the thing. You're gonna hit the thing. Oh my God! You hit the thing. Oh, the humanity!
I know that one.
Yeah?
That was when the first airplane crashed.
You do? I'll give you $100 if you can tell me who said that.
The Zeppelin fell and it was,
I'll give you $100 if you can tell me the guy or the date.
It was when the Zeppelin burned and crashed and all the humanity. I know that much. That's all I can.
Yeah, the first time you said airplane.
I was fucking... That was trolling. I was just... to piss off the internet.
That was the Hindenburg crash. And I couldn't tell you the name of the guy, but I could look it up. I think I probably have this totally wrong, but
Orson Welles.
No, it wasn't Orson. It was a reporter dude, but I think he was a reporter for the BBC, but I don't know if the BBC existed. I don't know.
Pre-BBC.
BBC has stringers everywhere. Like, if you drop that box, a BBC reporter would jump out of the back of the van where he's been waiting for 11 years just for something to happen here. What?
Someone used the retarded pallet.
The retarded pallet?
He doesn't have a
You
weight.
Can't say that. That's offensive.
It's okay, my brother's retarded.
Your brother's not retarded.
And then there's Tommy.
Okay, your brother's kind of retarded. You shouldn't say those things about Pat. What the fuck are you doing?
Oh man, I was hoping I had
wow.
a chip, but I didn't.
Wow, have a you suck at this.
Fine.
Do you want me to do it? Cause I can do it.
Yeah, now that I'm down to the last box.
Drive forklift better than you can. It's because it's a square pallet.
Well, it doesn't have the holes on it.
Yeah, it's the wooden one.
Wood ones usually have holes on
them. That's all right. You got that other pallet with all, that's made up of all the sides.
Yeah, and then when they made this one, they had no sides.
Yeah. That other one you can pick up from the top.
Yeah, the open side goes against another box, I'm going to say.
Yeah? You didn't like the other side? How the hell are you gonna do that?
Do what?
Oh, okay, I see it. I see it now. I'm with you. See, now you're really fucked.
I don't know what you're talking.
Come down. There you no, not that down. Boom out. There you go. Come. God, you suck at this. Stop. See, if you were really cool, you'd have had that on the end, because I don't know how you're going to push that up. Or you're just going to strap it there.
I'm not worried about it. I'm only moving 4 galers.
Well, we could get more.
Yeah, but the place I got to get more is where I drop them off anyway.
Oh, okay.
Ah.
Ah.
Ah. Poked a hole in your logic.
Really?
Catch up.
Oh God, can I catch up?
The whole 3 mile out.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think Moose could run that.
Whole 3 miles. Yeah, I've had this sucker up to 12.
12?
12.
That's just
I almost lost control at 12.
That's almost,
I tell
you. That's just crazy, man.
It's actually terrifying at 12 when we have this.
Yeah. So, I want to build something.
Okay.
I want to build, I found a guy who sells, you know, like BMX bike wheels that have like the mag style with the plastic, like 5 spokes on a bike wheel. I found a guy who sells 17 inch, they're spoked wheels.
Okay.
But they have polyurethane railroad wheel on the outside.
Okay, so you bike down it.
No. You don't put it on a bike. Because a proper rail wheel only works on one side, right? Because they've got a cone to it.
Right.
But he sells sets of 4.
So you want to make
about,
a good... Oh,
it's
you
about $1,600 bucks for
a
set of 4.
Pedal
hell, we put a motor on it.
Doobie's little Briggs and
it
Stratton.
It could be, but yeah. we make it long enough where it'll just barely fit on the trailer.
Okay,
so that's how we determine our length. The width is easy. It's 4'8.5" between centers on railroad tracks. Yes, I know that off the top of my head. Shut up. But we could do this.
We could.
We put a little putt engine on it.
And then we just have camera mounts all over the
place.
Oh,
God, we'd have fun as hell. And we work it out because it's not hard to find abandoned railroad tracks.
Oh, you know what? We don't have to throw away your Mazda seats. Keep those for that.
Yeah, we can put the Mazda seats on it. And it'd be light enough you could hang it from the ceiling when it's not in use. So it doesn't take up any space.
Oh,
it's a good idea.
Look into it.
We'd have to raise about $2,000 to build it. I don't know what we'd make the frame out of. I want to make the frame out of 80-20 because that'd be awesome.
It would be awesome. But, and it's smooth enough. Yeah, I mean, I'd worry about like making a go-kart out of it, but something that doesn't have to.
Yeah, it doesn't need suspension.
Yeah,
so you think about that. We'd have to do like a $2,000 fundraiser.
If you're doing that long, though, I'd almost suggest 6 wheels.
Why?
I don't know how strong. You said these are bicycle wheels, aren't they?
Well, they're bike wheels, but they're rated to 300 pounds a piece.
And then also just the flex and the aluminum you'd want.
And it's like $1,600 for a set of wheels. So, I mean, they're expensive wheels.
I'm sure we'll come up with something. We're smart people.
Oh shit, Batman.
What?
I got butt wiggles sitting on the ground. We got so much wind.
I said it was a bad idea.
Also, just for kicks, I broke the rudder thing in a crash, so I have no rudder.
You're just asking for it.
I'm asking for trouble.
I didn't want to come out here and just watch you crash a plane.
Yeah? It's gonna be okay.
I did.
Yeah, fuck you. I love you too, Batman. No, I fixed this one last night, so...
Oh, yeah, because, you know, it totally has rudder.
Well, I got ailerons, I got elevators, I can get by without rudder. Rudders are expensive. I don't have the parts to fix it.
Just a little bit of foam. A popsicle stick, come on now.
No, it's not the foam, it's the little part that attaches.
Right, a little hot glue and a little, balsa wood, yeah.
Yeah, there's definitely wind.
Rudders are for pussies.
Doing alright without a rudder, but that wind's kicking my ass. Well, that's a lot of wind. Here, motor off, let's see what the wind does. Perfect 8-point landing.
Nope. Oh shit.
That was
ugly. Oh, here. Hang on a minute.
I gotta put that rudder control line back in there. My tape came loose. We're gonna take off. Kind of into the wind.
Totally legit.
Jesus! Let's get out of that. I can tell which way the wind's pointing. It'd be really cool if I get back over here.
Good luck. Just don't hit the dude in the.
I got a 10 mile an hour
bucket.
Plane and a 20 mile an hour wind. Off, we're gliding now. Engine on, we're crashing. Oh, bird. Go say hi to the bird. Bird's gaining altitude way better than I am. He's much better equipped to handle wind.
He's gonna start mating with it if you're not careful. He's hanging around though. He's confused.
Yeah, he's like, what the hell are you? Oh, another bird.
Hey, Bill, look at this asshole. What is he drunk? Like. I don't know if the camera can actually see any of this.
You know what happens after you catch them? You saw Alfred Hitchcock the birds, right?
Oh, Minkus!
I know, I saw the captain's block.
Okay.
I know I'm
Wow,
screwed.
Look at that smacking around. That's really cool. Batman is pretty cool having an airplane with ailerons.
Right. If I was in a sailplane still, this would suck.
Well, especially since you have no rudder.
Yeah. Oh, that was close. Yeah, but I got that inverted loop.
Right.
All right, let's bring it in for a nice, happy, easy landing.
Into the wind, yes. Remember, you don't have rudders.
Oh, yeah, but I still got steerable nose wheel.
A little bit.
Yeah, but it's steerable nose wheel can't overcome the air power against it, so. So how you doing today, sir?
Good, you?
I'm groovy. My plane landed with all the parts intact.
I see that, and it landed in one piece, too.
It did. That's a novel treat. And then the wind dies.
Fuck!
And then it comes back like a hurricane.
Woo! Just keeping you on top of things, Ben. So how do you feel about an adventure way out of town? It's about a half hour drive from here.
As long as I'm back with enough time that I can do my father-son mentoring tonight.
What, do you want to do that today?
I didn't know. I don't know if we want to do it today. I don't know. It might be a good day to do it, Batman.
Because I'm not going to be
If we got Minkus and Casey...
We also have Joe.
No, we also have Joe. He's a bit of a man.
Yeah. You want to do it today?
I'll empty the cardboard and shit out of the van and hook the trailer up to it.
I'll land this and we'll make it happen.
I got the key still.
Yep. Going around again.
Just don't hit the nice guy in the bucket truck.
Alright.
That would have been kind of funny. They just smack right into him.
Request permission. No, the fun one was the cat. The cat's still my favorite.
Request permission for a flyby? Negative, Ghost Rider. The pattern is full.
We had a cat hanging out in the parking lot, like right over here. A couple weeks ago?
I wasn't here for that one.
I thought you were here for that.
Oh, no, it was late night. It was very good. But we had a cat out here. And I'm flying really low and slow. It's awesome. And a cat chasing my plane. All right, so yeah, that'll be the plan. Let's haul in the trash, scrap, empty the van, all that jazz. And we'll send the van out with the trailer. I'll get a couple people together, and head off and rock that. I've got a 1 o'clock meeting, so I don't know. By the time you get back to the scrapyard, I should be cool.
Okay.
I got a 1 o'clock meeting, got a fire truck.
Oh, that's right. That's
right.
Yeah,
fire truck then. You want a fire truck?
It's free.
They're never free, but you might be able to get the truck donated. Fire truck for portable science demonstrations?
Yeah. I had a friend that actually bought an old one of the van ambulances for like $800.
I want to get a box ambulance, not a van type. I want a box one for the same thing. Something we can take around and do guerrilla science with. Plane land. All the parts are there.
Okay. Now, when you've got it, like the close in shot, you want it out a little bit, like you got it, because otherwise the microphones are on top.
Okay.
Okay. So if you've got it up tight like this, I hand this off to a lot of fat guys. We got a lot of big guys around here. So you hand it to a fat guy and they've got like an 8-gallon lung capacity and it just sucks. You want it out a little bit, but you're doing this delicate, dainty little artist hold. You can't do that. Okay, you've got to hold it like a lumberjack. You want to be in there, okay? So you want to make sure that you don't have your hands over any buttons or over the microphones. Now on this camera, you're actually a little easier because the microphones are on the front because it's a camera. So flip it up. See those little dots? Those are the microphones. Okay, so you wanna get right, just grab it! Grab it! Own it! Yes. God! Alright, see. Now you've got the other hold is the biddle grip, like that. Okay. That's a biddle grip. And you need to look up what a biddle grip is from. Because once you start learning about biddle grips, college gets way more fun. Okay, a biddle grip is something that can serve you very, very well in college. Alright, okay. It's a little bit. little freaked out.
No, I need to look up what a fiddle crib is.
You need to know this. You, sir, are going on a field trip today if you want to.
Okay.
Do you have to leave at any specific time? Do you have to where you got to be?
Like normal quitting time. I could probably even stay a little later.
Okay, cool. Because we got to go out of town. We're going on a field trip.
Okay.
You got appropriate shoes. Cool. It's dusty. It's raw. You're going to need a face mask.
Oh, yeah. I saw the blog.
You saw the blog? Okay, you're going there.
Okay.
And we're going to get that piece of equipment in.
Sweet.
But I've got you here today, and I've got Minkus. So we're just basically, we're getting all the burly fuckers together. Not you!
No.
Not you! Because you don't know what a biddle grip is. That's not true. It's totally because you're black. But everybody... Okay. All right. But we're going to take all the big burly guys out there. Don't laugh at that! That's a terrible joke!
I know!
That's horribly offensive!
Yes, sir!
Oh, okay. But yeah, we're getting the computer.
Oh, the comments on YouTube are going to be great. They're like, did he just say that? But yes, we're getting an analog computer.
Okay.
So, all right, that's the plan. We're going to do the scrap and then we're off. It's a half-hour drive. It's not that far, but it's a half-hour drive. It's a lovely drive, though, and it's very, very picturesque. We should send you to document this for blog, actually. That would be kind of fun. Do you have anywhere, like, do you have a scheduled date? You got to be anywhere?
Well,
are you delicate?
Not really.
Okay. I don't know. I'm looking at your camera holes. I'm starting to wonder about you. He has no idea what he's in for today. Yeah, what do you got? Okay. What do you need from Munich? Oh, you have a whole list.
Drills.
This is why we can't have nice things!
I'm gonna go see my best
dog. Okay. Huh? She's got a whole shopping list for Nemec. I'm blaming Scott. We should have him show you around. He can teach you about camera stuff too. When you get good at this, you graduate to a big camera. I think we should send him today as camera dude.
Yeah?
I'm gonna ask Elizabeth if that's okay. I have to ask your boss. Let's see.
Hi, I'm Joe. Teddy. Teddy, are you an AV intern then?
Yeah.
All right.
Teddy's going to be okay. I think.
I don't know.
Hey, Liz. What's Teddy's focus?
General production.
Okay. Do you have him assigned on anything today?
Just doing a little test blog, why?
Can I send him for a little bit of RAR blog? Did you see yesterday's captain's blog?
No.
We have an analog computer in a terrifying house way the hell outside of town. I'm taking Joe out there because he's butch. And I was thinking of taking him just to shoot blog.
You mean on your blog?
Yeah, it'd air on the captain's blog. But he'd actually get to shoot video on his first day that would air in front of 1,000 people, which would be kind of cool. And it's a little bit insane and testy and RAR and dangerous.
Jeez. Signed the waivers and it's still technically a test.
You signed the waivers!
Well, even better, yeah. His mother signed the waivers.
How old are you?
17.
Oh, you're fucked. Okay. Yeah, we can tell
him. I am okay with this. You can take both cameras and everything.
All right, cool. You're shooting for real blog today.
That one doesn't have a spare battery, though, so he may need
I'll send him with a good camera. I'll give him the backup blog camera. All right. It's going to be cool. Now I'm going to see if I can go and you get to ride in Daddy's car. Oh, poor bastard, it's his first. You're 17?
Yeah.
Really?
He goes to the aviation school near the airport.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Are you into aviation?
No, physics.
You go into the aviation school and you're not into aviation?
Yeah, but it was a...
But you're at the aviation school.
Yeah. It's a small school.
I know.
Like a huge school.
So you're taking up a spot at the aviation school that some kid who actually is studying aviation could have. It's a very small school. It's a limited school.
Yeah.
And you can't tell me the fundamentals of an airfoil.
Oh, I can.
You can?
I think.
You think. Draw me an airfoil.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
Here, you'll need a marker.
I learned this freshman year.
So. Okay, draw me an airfoil.
So it goes down. And then down. Well, no, that's...
You want to draw me a proper airfoil?
I
fix your airfoil. Fix it. Fix it. You sit in a corner and you think about what you did there. All right. Now, what are the fundamental forces acting on that airfoil that have to be maintained in balance?
There is the air passing.
No, the forces. I don't want to know about the airflow. Tell me about the forces. We'll get to the airflow. We haven't even gotten to that yet.
Chris.
Come on. Come on. Four forces. You're telling me you're into physics, damn it. I want forces.
Forces.
Okay. Give me the forces. There's like 1,000 people watching you right now. There's like 1,000 people watching you. Okay. And they're all commenting and they're all making fun on you. Give me the forces. There's four. There's four forces on that airfoil that you need to know. What are they? Come on, right now. You're in the Aviation Academy. There's drag. Okay, drag. Where's it go? What side? What side? What fucking side?
I live for this.
Here, you need that.
Drag! It's on the back!
Okay.
Drag! What's the next one? What else? What's an airfoil part of?
It's a part of
an airplane!
Plane.
Right? Okay. What airplanes do?
They fly.
They fly! So, what would that be? What do you need to fly?
You need to fly a plane.
What's the one on top? Which way does a fucking airplane go?
Forward!
Up! What makes it go up? What does an airfoil generate?
Aside from drag.
What does an airfoil generate? Do it! You know this! I know you fucking know this!
I know this, but I don't want to be wrong.
Oh, you're going to be wrong. There's no right. No matter what you do, there's 10,000 people commenting about the many ways in which you're an idiot and I'm a horrible cunt. You know this. I know you know this. What is it?
I can't think.
The reason you don't need to do standardized
testing. I would be awesome at the SATs.
Lift?
Yeah.
Lift?
Would that be
yes.
Lift? Draw it. Draw it.
I can't even breathe.
Oh, we're just getting started.
Okay.
All right, okay, you've got drag and lift. Now, what balance is drag? What do you need to overcome drag? I'll give you a hint. Push on my hand. Push on my hand. All right, now, what do you need to overcome drag?
Well.
What do you need to overcome drag? Huh?
Wait.
No, not weight. Weight's bad.
Yeah,
we'll get to it. We haven't even gotten to weight yet. What overcomes drag? What overcomes drag? What overcomes drag? You know this! What overcomes drag? I'll give you a hint.
I'm supposed to put my
arms. What are you getting right now? What are you getting right now? Yes, push, which is?
There's so many.
How do you push something? Thrust! Motherfucker! Thrust! I don't know how I feel about my son being
here.
All right, you have drag and you have thrust.
Okay.
Right? Opposing forces.
Yeah.
Right? You have lift? What's the opposite lift? Jump!
Pull.
Jump! Why'd you come back down?
Gravity.
There you go!
Okay.
Josh is in a meeting in the lobby.
Oh. So what are the four fundamental forces on airfoil?
Lift, drag, gravity, and thrust.
Very good. Thank you, sir. You will never forget those again, will you?
That's for you.
Physics is the study of energy. In order to teach it, you need to have energy.
Are you feeling the energy?
Yes.
We'll be back. Oh, it was a good idea that can't happen. That makes me sad. All right, so you're donating a Ford.
Yeah.
Okay. A Taurus. Ford Taurus.
There's three issues.
Three issues.
Yeah.
Okay, one, it's a Ford Taurus.
This lever just got disconnected, you know, that little bar?
Yeah. That's easy to fix. And I'll bet there's a lever on the inside.
Oh, that works.
Okay, well, see, and you're fine. Yeah. You don't need that outside one. You need to get out for safety, but the outside, you don't need to. There's three other... It's fine. This is a great car. I can get you into this car for $200 today. I can do this. You could drive this
I
off the lot.
I paid $1,500 for it because a friend was selling it.
Yeah.
The back brakes, when you they seem to like stick.
Okay.
When you start up, they go ding, and I mean, so I'd look at them.
We'll just disconnect those. You don't need back brakes anymore.
No, you don't.
All the braking happens in the front.
And
what do you need
work.
Back
the
brakes
front
for?
Works
yeah, you're fine. It's great. It's
okay, I got everything out of mine out of it. It only has one key, so don't lose it.
Okay. Or get copies. Which
no, you can't. You know, can't get copies? It's got the little chip on the key, okay. So you have to do certain electronic things in order to use copies.
Yeah, we got to rip out that whole RFID bullshit and just replace it with a push button and a toggle switch. That's damn it. That's how you do it.
Yeah. Anyway.
So this is a donation, and we can do anything we want to it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I want the plate. I want the plate in a little bit.
Because that's a special plate?
No, just liability.
Oh, okay. Cool. Well, thank you for the car, sir. That'll probably end up being used by staff.
Whatever.
Be my guess.
Having a day.
Time is 13:52 hours. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Chris Bowden. Welcome to the Geek Group. We've got viewer mail. Also, everybody at home needs to say hi to Teddy. Come here. The world needs to meet you. You're the new intern.
He's
this
new
is
too.
Teddy. He's a new intern. There's another one. No, there's two new interns. Come here. Come here. What the hell are you doing?
I'm recording myself.
Okay, and
microphone, why not?
It's your first day with a shotgun, isn't it?
No.
Really?
I don't have a boom, so
what?
We have a shotgun.
Not eating the shotgun microphone might cause, you know, over-pressurization of sound pressure levels, which would cause the signal to clip, which in a digital recorder would tend to suck!
Well, I wasn't doing that. I wasn't yelling at him, you know?
Chris!
Oh, don't do that.
Be nice to the children.
He's walking around
there are.
With a talk.
Wait, yeah, you know what the bitch is? My dinosaurs are wrong. What is your name?
I'm Sean.
Don't tell me that.
I'm Sean!
I know your name.
My name's Sean.
So wait, it's Sean?
So it's
Moose!
It's Sean.
Shotgun Sean.
Is that confirmed?
Shotty.
100%, that is absolutely no doubt where it's coming from?
Well, they could be coming to it, but that's where it's
okay.
All kinds of handling.
So, everybody watching live, what is
this? All over the place?
Card reader cleaner. Such a thing exists? You have to clean card readers?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I didn't know that till just now.
You have to clean everything.
Oh, there's lots of them.
In and out of other things.
There's lots of them.
Not a sex joke.
Who is this?
Slide it.
Totally a sex joke.
It's gone now. It's gone. It's just...
Con.
Alright, so they make card reader cleaners. And Mr. Bellatini informs us that you have to clean anything that goes into or out of something else. So I give it approximately 72 hours until dick wipes show up. By the way, right now, some daft bent thought it'd be a really good idea to initiate a DDoS attack against the Geek Group. Their IP address is 93.174.93.82. That IP address again is 93.174.93.82. Enjoy yourselves. What's next? Right now their router just burst into flames. This is my digital equivalent of fuck me. No, fuck you! Feel free to do anything you like with that IP address.
The computer's now just screaming, "We are anonymous." And burning.
Oh! It's from Edmund! Insert clever message here. I strongly dislike it, worn out plugged sockets. I like strongly your English.
Fred, that makes sense.
It's Ed. We love it. 12-3 SJTW, 3-wire, grounded, 15 amp, 125 volt. I found out why, even though it's 12 gauge, it's only rated to 15 amps.
Do tell.
The reason is, and this is actually kind of cool, to rate it to 20 amps, they'd have to put the different plug on. So the wire can handle 20 amps of current, but the socket. But you can, with this cable, cut this off and put a different one on, but then you can't plug it in there. So, now you know. Thank you, Ed, sir. Come on over and Mr. Bellatini will wipe your dick clean. Because we do that here now. gonna be a thing all day.
A new professional service.
No, you charge by the inch.
Won't be making much around here.
Story of my life. I'm getting the discount. Oh, hey, how about that shit? Huh. What do we got here? California Tools. It's a Goodyear heavy duty rubber 3/8 inch by 100 foot all rubber, all weather rubber airline. God, that's hard
to replace the shitty one that
all weather rubber
appears
airline.
In the machine shop.
Yay.
Ooh.
It's pink, it's thick, and it's quite long.
Chris, are you available?
What world is that pink?
That's red.
Yeah, it's desaturated red.
I'm desaturated, but yes, I'm available. How can I help you? Waldo is here. He wants to buy a laptop. He wants to talk to you about that. Maybe some other stuff.
Okay, he needs to talk to Jerry. I'm doing Vera Mail. He can wait a minute.
Hi, Jerry.
Man,
we got so we got hoes from different area codes.
That's it! That's all we've got. So, for the two new interns, where's the other one?
He's hiding.
Get the fuck over here. What are you hiding in the back? You think I'm not going to pick on you if you hide in the back?
No.
It doesn't work that
way. I'm picking on you.
I know.
Okay.
I know this. You stuck your microphone down your pants.
Was it good for you?
Yeah, it was great.
Okay. You get a Sharpie.
Sweet.
Were you recording?
Yeah. I was recording all of it.
I'm putting the audio. I need the audio from that. I'm going to put that in the vlog. And you get a Sharpie. Welcome to the Geek Group, gentlemen. Have I abused you yet today?
A little. I
screamed at him for a good 10 minutes. I thought he might. I didn't know if he was going to like pass out from laughing or what. What are the four fundamental forces acting on an airfoil?
On an airfoil?
On an airfoil. A wing. What?
A wing?
Do we know who sent this?
What the fuck is this? This was from Ed Reser. This is anonymous. And this is, I don't know.
There was anonymous too.
I have no idea. There are no names on the box. No names on the receipt. It says California Tools. It came in member donations. It came off our wish list.
Okay.
So they came off the wish
all
list.
I needed one.
That's everything I got. Huh? Oh yeah! It's your first day. Let me wipe the dust off this. Have you ever had Vegemite?
I've never had it.
Do you know what Vegemite is?
More or less.
You're not supposed to eat it with your fingers.
It is.
It's.
That'll put hair on your chest. That'll put hair on places of your body you don't even know you have yet.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah?
Good.
Try it.
Good. The fact you had to wipe dust off of it. It was a sealed container.
Vegemite! It was a sealed container once.
I don't know the four things that act on an aerofoil. Lift and drag, probably two.
There's two. Where are the other two?
The other two.
Okay.
Air pressure, one of them, but I doubt air pressure really matters.
Air pressure matters a lot.
Well, I guess a wing doesn't matter. Wing doesn't do anything in space, necessarily. So.
What?
Do you see a lot of airfoils in space?
Do
I? No.
Exactly.
No.
Well,
you know what? There's no fucking atmosphere. I've never been to space, but I know there's no air there.
Well,
space shuttles
sorry.
Have airfoils.
I'm not.
Huh?
Space shuttle has airfoils.
Because a space shuttle is a really shitty glider
you
when
said,
it comes back.
You
shut up.
You don't see them anymore.
Your airfoils are wrong.
Okay.
Alright, well, that's four. So we have air pressure, lift, drag.
Well, air pressure is fundamental.
Right.
Yeah, you can use air pressure as lift.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so I'll give you that. Okay, all right. So you've got lift and drag.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the that's these two. What are these two?
Gravity. I don't know. I'm just taking comments from the peanut gallery.
Yeah.
I could just look it up on my phone.
Frost.
Right.
Frost.
Anytime you put anything in and out, you gotta clean it, remember?
That's what my mom always told me.
Hang on, I know what you need. I've got exactly what you need.
I've got it right here. He's got what I need.
I have. Give me your microphone.
Here you go.
Focus faster. Oh my god, your camera sucks. It actually sucks.
If you want to focus, you put it here like that and then come down on it. There you go.
Too easy.
There. Sin no more.
Thank you.
All right. That's lunch.
We'll be back! What?
What?
What? Winner of the Hoss hat.
Hey, Chris, do you want to fire
the Hoss hat or the Bolt Depot hat?
This is just turning into a clusterfuck. We are. He is. Where's...
It's great how that works. I can still hear anything that comes over the radio. What the fuck do you got? What do you want?
LJMA1204.
He's a dick.
He's the first one that got that actually replied with a proper explanation of the use of a sex bowl.
Yeah?
I'm sorry, not the
stripper bowl.
The stripper bowl.
Did he copy it off Wikipedia or did he do it for reals?
No. He copied it off of
Mutsumi website.
Mutsumi website.
Mutsumi?
Yeah, it's right there. You forgot to cut that part out.
You mean Mutsumi?
Mutsumi, whatever. It was the first.
M-I-S is not Moots. It's Miss.
Moots.
Mutsumi.
Got a little Moots ring.
Something like that. So he's a guy. LJ Mike wins the hat and the stripper.
Unless
bowl.
You say no.
I'm cool with it.
Okay.
LJ Mike. You're the judge. He's the judge of the thing. I won't judge you. Because I love you. I'm here to love you. And share the joy. Teddy!
Are we done?
I think we're cool. Thank you, LJ Mike. You're the winner of the day.
In several states in the USA, it's still legal for an employer to discriminate against an employee based on sexual preference and orientation. Being gay, lesbian, or transgender is a fireable offense, and that's bullshit. So...
Give me your twinks, your bears, your lipstick lesbians yearning to code PHP. Give me your dykes, your kinksters, your furries, and transgenders looking for more. Send these, the rainbowed sparkly code poets, to me. Compile with us. We don't care whom you adore.
Seriously, folks, are you LGBTQ or a champion for their cause? Do you have mad web developing skills? Then we want to talk to you. Visit this link and fill out an application today. Where you are in the world doesn't matter, so get in touch. Straight, bigoted asshats need not apply. In fact, we'll laugh at you if you do.
You're recording now. You're shooting blog. Pre-flight. Wind is messing with me bad. Let's get it out over the open field.
Ah! I hit the grass. Stay there, you're Oop. Cool.
Okay.
successful landing if you can take off from it again. Left and I can't land now. I lost my front wheel. So, we got a problem. What do you recommend?
Can you increase drag and then we try to catch it?
You mean slow down?
Yeah. Slow down a lot and somebody get ready to just like catch it or something.
What's your plan? Catch it?
I don't know. I've never really flown an RC plane, so
you
don't
can
know.
Catch it.
Hmm?
You can catch it. Especially the micro section. That airplane only weighs a few ounces. I could fly it into you and it wouldn't hurt.
Yeah, we should try to catch it.
Yeah. Alright. Let's go downwind a bit.
You want to catch it?
Come around. Alright, we're coming. We're into the wind. Catch it?
Oh.
You didn't catch it.
It was really
you
low.
You didn't catch it.
I know.
Here. Okay. Safely on the ground now. We're
yeah.
cool.
Yeah.
Back in the air. Damn it! Now we have to catch it again.
Okay. So do I catch it with one hand? Like,
I don't know.
Alright, I guess.
I think we should let Joe try to catch it. Joe, you wanna try and catch it? Sure. For safety? Because landing is dangerous without a nose wheel.
Yeah. Yep. Got one of those propellers that's like razor sharp and no. I did.
All those people died. We gotta go back. It's time. Doogie's gonna be back any second. So see, you being in the Aviation Academy,
yes,
you can come here and learn about airplanes. You can learn how to fly airplanes. That's
yes.
the point. Did they teach you about control surfaces?
I think freshman year.
Yeah?
I feel like they have.
What year are you in?
I am a senior.
You're a senior?
Yep, 4 years.
You're attending the Aviation Academy?
Yes.
And you don't know control surfaces?
Yes.
I find this disturbing.
Yes.
Okay, what are these?
Oh, those are, no, I want to say either flaps or ailerons or one of the two.
What are you going to go with?
I have
what
a...
What are your options?
Flaps or ailerons.
Hi. We're getting better.
These are ailerons.
Knew it.
Some airplanes have flaps as well. Flaps are ailerons that usually only go one way, and they're towards the inside of the wing.
Okay.
What are these?
Which ones? Oh, those, elevators.
Very good.
Ooh.
What's the vertical one?
The vertical one, that is a... can't remember.
Boats have them too. Rudder.
Rudder, yep.
On this airplane, the rudder doesn't move. Because this airplane is sad. There you go. Swing it out. There you go.
Okay.
Alright, so what's on your mind, sir?
Nothing, to be honest.
You're having a rather unusual first day for you, I'm guessing. This has got to be kind of weird.
Yeah, I thought I was just going to edit videos, to be honest.
Are you having a more interesting day than you anticipated?
Yes.
Are you happy?
Yes.
Okay. What are your thoughts of the Geek Group so far on your first day?
I think it's the most awesome place ever, and that I would most likely be here for a long time if I can be.
Good. I think so. I don't know. Like, you might turn out to be an asshole.
Really? Turning down to get to the phone.
Okay.
Where do you want me to turn? I can stay on Leonard and go straight until we get outside of town and then Luke Fulton, or I can take, we can't take Seward down because of construction.
College should get us past the construction on Fulton, so turn on to College, we should be good.
College gets really skinny. You sure you don't want to hang and go down a little bit further like Diamond or something? College narrows right up, especially by Channel 8.
Maybe we'll go further down. Lafayette then, maybe?
I don't know. I'll get down that way and see what looks good.
You guys, I can always take Fuller, too.
I like Fuller. You want to do Fuller?
I'll do Fuller.
All right, Fuller it is. Everybody turns right on Fuller.
Roger that. Over.
So, what were you expecting?
I sit at a computer and just edit videos.
Actually, I was gonna say, you know, we could take them all the way down to Clayton and dump us right in the Fuller.
Okay, so that's what you were expecting.
Yeah.
How would you describe your day? Like what happened?
Well...
You can point that at you, too.
Oh, okay.
I'm not special.
Okay. Well, I was yelled at. I had two tours. What else? I memorized the forces acting on an airfoil. Memorized.
What are the four forces acting on an airfoil?
Lift, gravity, thrust, and drag.
Very good.
I was on the viewer mail bit thing section. Where I was yelled at again. What else? Yeah, I think that was like the major part. Me being yelled at.
That's just your whole day today, is
yeah.
Being yelled at. I'm okay with that.
I mean, it wasn't like...
I'm very abusive. I'm very mean. I'm a horrible person. Just ask any of the staff. I'm actually a very horrible person, and I don't like anybody. At least that's what you have to tell people. You know why I yell at you. Because I'm racist.
Well, oh, yeah, yeah.
I'm a horrible person, and I'm a racist. That's what it is.
Yeah, I was... He introduced me as the black kid. I mean, which... It wasn't bad. It was just there.
Yeah, but what makes you the black kid? You don't get to be the... We already got the black kid.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, like you're the first black guy we've ever had.
Well.
You ain't that special.
You made it feel like that.
Yes, that's your one defining characteristic, totally.
Black guy.
So describe your day so far. What else you got? You've been hanging out with Joe a lot.
Well, yeah. He gave me a tour twice.
You can point. Oh. Joe gave you two tours?
Yeah.
So it's like NAM in here?
Yeah.
Okay. Why did you get two tours from Joe?
Because,
did you get lost and forget or something?
No, the guy,
Joe's the high guy, well, just so you know. If you get to be the black guy, Joe gets to be the high guy.
Okay. what's we call him? Shotgun. Shotgun, he popped up, like, out of nowhere, and he needed a tour.
Ah.
And, yeah, I kind of just followed him again. Because,
that's Sean's nickname now, or Shotgun?
Well, that's what I remembered him by.
Oh, okay.
Because the Shotgun and the... Yeah. And, yeah, I think that's... What else?
Just fucking turn right there, sure.
No lights.
Hey, Batman, what's your 20? I think this is fun. Hey, Batman, do you have a copy? I don't know if you can hear me, but I'm turning on Fuller. This is Captain, turning north or, yeah, south on Fuller. I can tell that you're transmitting, but you are unreadable. I'm on Fuller, headed south. There is construction, but you should be all right. We gotta slow down. We're too far ahead of him. See, our job is to ride ahead of the big truck so that we can spot any major shit. Like, if he needs to divert or be rerouted, that's our job. We're basically reconnaissance.
Recon! Yeah!
What?
It became kind of like a natural
reaction.
You're
going to be the most high-wound-up motherfucker in America by the end of the day. You're going to go home and just be this twitchy little dude. Your mom's going to be like, what did they do to you? Nothing! I just need to lay down for a while. I just need a juice box and a cookie. I'll be okay. A little nap. He yelled at me, Mom. She's gonna see the blog. She's gonna be like, that was your first day? He's horrible. And then after they turned the camera off, he hit me, Mom. He hit me with a hose. So you're having a horrible first day. You hate it here, I can tell. You have to tell everybody else that like I'm mean as hell and you hated your first day, it was horrible, and you wish you could get out of it, but you're already signed in so you can't change it, and then none of the other guys will want to come here. That'd be cool. Otherwise, everybody's gonna want to come here. We're gonna be popular. It's gonna suck. It takes all the fun out. Captain checking in at Fuller in Michigan. It's a rescue mom. Get a shot of that. Look at that. That's a rescue mom. You know what a rescue mom is? Sometimes moms get separated from their families.
Oh.
And they get lost and they get hungry. So other people have to adopt that mom and take care of them.
Oh.
And yeah, that's what a rescue mom is.
Oh.
They get her a new husband, she builds a new family. It takes years. Puppy over there. That's a sad dog. That dog needs a window down.
a job up here years ago for like a minute and a half. I think I actually worked there for like a week, if that. It was up here at the auto parts place. See the AC Delco sign?
Yeah.
I used to work there. And my job was to drive a pickup truck around town and deliver car parts. I think I lasted 2 weeks.
I hate that.
I don't remember why I got fired, but I'm pretty sure the root cause was I got bored. I've been fired from a lot of jobs for no other reason than I got bored. Because you get bored and you start thinking, well, that'd be fun to do. I could do that. I don't know what street we're on. I don't know what street we're on.
Yeah, I can't.
Oh, shit. We're going to have to turn.
That's full.
That's full. Oh, that's what we got to turn anyway, so we're okay. Captain checking in at the light at Fulton on Fuller.
I'm at Michigan and Fuller.
Cool, you're getting close to me. I can actually, are you by the big orange semi-truck?
He's like 3 cars behind me.
Well, I can see him, so yeah, you're line of sight at the moment. The next light, you're going to want to turn left. That's Fulton as you come up the hill.
Hello there, thank you. Over.
Here to help. Now look at the back of the camera and see what the timer says.
It
How many
says,
minutes have you got?
10.
10? All right.
Well, 11.
The camera only records for 22 minutes.
Okay.
So you got to be aware of that and right. Be ready to stop the clip and start a new one. It'll just stop.
All right.
So when you get really close, you just, like once you cross 20 minutes, you wait for like a pause in the action. Hit the red button back here, that stops it. Wait about 3 seconds and then hit it again and it'll start a new clip.
Okie doke.
See, that guy's kicking. But we're doing all right. See the guy ahead of us just rode a red light?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, you know what that is? That's the catering company. Like, there's only one.
Fire truck.
Where?
Right there.
Well, yeah, but he's not doing anything.
Yeah.
He's just hanging out.
Yeah.
So did you hear about our fire truck? We're trying to. We have a shot. I found a fire truck nearby that's for sale, and they wanted $5,000 for it, which is, you know, a pretty good price. But I talked them down to $3,500. Hey, church is for sale. Buy a church, that'd be fun. But I talked them down to $3,500 and they agreed to hold on to it for a couple weeks so that we could take a shot at doing a fundraiser for it. So that's the two of the three things that have to happen for us to get a fire truck. First, I have to get down to the lowest possible price because it's going to be paid for with donated money, so it's my duty to get the price as low as possible, so I had to negotiate. So I did that. Went from $5,000 down to $3,500. The second thing is, I have to make sure it's feasible that they'll allow us enough time and say, okay, we'll give you a shot and we will agree to absolutely not sell this to anybody else for X amount of time. Because if we were to, like, launch a fundraiser and get all the money donated to get a fire truck and then they'd sold it to Bob, then we're screwed because you can't do that. It's unethical. So, now the third thing is, Doogie and Batman have to go all the way out there and examine it up close, get a lot of pictures, and this is to verify A, that it's in good condition and that we do indeed want to buy it, and B, it gives us content to show the IRC in the live stream when we do the fundraiser so they can see it, because they're going to want to vet it and say, okay, well, yeah, it's a decent fire truck. I want to help on that. I want to contribute. So that's going to happen next, and we'll launch a fundraiser for them. Then we'll get a fire truck. And we're going to use the fire truck to drive around and do science demonstrations, because you can take a fire truck, take it right downtown to Rose Park Circle, park it right on the mall, and have the whole, like, all fire trucks got all kinds of doors and cabinets and shit. You fill those with science demos, just science stuff, just cool shit. And, like, I might do something really awesome, like mount a Tesla coil on top of the fire truck. Because the only thing cooler than a fire truck is the fire truck with the Tesla coil on it. Or maybe lasers.
That would be pretty cool, lasers. Tesla coils on top.
Tesla coils and lasers, man. And then, if you got a fire truck with Tesla coils and lasers, you totally get girls. I don't know if this is the road I want or not. I just got off my road. We might have just screwed up. We might have screwed up bad. I don't know, I need a street sign. Because the road just before, I was talking to you. I was talking to you and I wasn't paying attention. Now we're lost. Do you know where you are?
Not really.
Neither do I. But we're on Fulton, we're on the right road. We're doing great.
Woohoo!
See? I'm never wrong and I never lie. Ever. Ever.
Ever.
Which is why we are totally on the right road. We're on Fulton Street. Which way are we going?
Not sure.
We're going east. You know how you can tell? Sun's behind us.
Oh, okay.
I didn't realize that.
What's your time?
15 and 48 seconds.
Okay. Ask me something. Anything you want.
What's your favorite thing to do?
Science. Like, it breaks down specifically in there, but like if I had to choose between like throwing 50 foot arcs with a Tesla coil or having sex with a supermodel, Tesla coil. I don't even have to think about that. Tesla coil. Though there is a formula there that involves the hotness of the girl versus the length of the arcs.
Yeah.
But at 50 feet, Tesla coil. Hands down. Falls into big enough to be really impressive, small enough to be easy to move.
What's this?
Hey, what's blue and white and sleeps four?
Consumer's
power truck. Alright, well this is going to be pretty boring for like the next 15 minutes, so we should probably turn that off. Do you know how?
Yeah.
Press the red. KC, can you hear me on the radio?
I got nothing.
You can't hear me?
No.
All right.
Swing! Stop! Yeah, turn the turn right. Okay. He's got mad skills. Mad skills. He's a for real truck driver, dude.
He's a for real truck.
He's a for serious truck driver. He's got like a CDL and shit. I know, right?
You don't want to pull that straight again.
He'll get there. He's got this.
Okay.
He's got to miss the house. Yeah, it's pretty bad.
I can smell everything. Seriously, we don't get any of the boats?
No, we don't get any of the boats.
Oh.
Sorry. This all goes in the van.
It'll survive.
We gotta put the boats back where we got them, too.
Right.
Okay. This goes in the van. So you want to see what we came here for? Come here and take a look. Come on in. That's what we're here for. Is that beautiful or what?
What's that? Gorgeous.
Yep. All right. We got to move this boat.
All right. I'm going to have Doogie start tearing apart this guy right here.
What? That? Okay.
While
cool.
We move everything.
All right. All right. Get him a mask.
On the side of the van, there's a bunch of respirators.
Okay. Okay. Go get one.
Doogie.
Are you having fun? Are you ready for the adventure?
Absolutely.
Okay.
I guess I'll give you a call when I'm done with this.
Do you have any kind of
might make you
tools?
Oh yeah.
Like we
brought everything. We've done this before.
Oh, I don't doubt that.
Yeah. I just don't know if anyone remembered it.
Oh yeah, we're cool. All
right,
you, sir, Lewis.
I told you about that internship that I have. Hold on one second.
Who are you talking to?
My dad.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, I'll be right with you.
Okay, because I'll talk to your dad.
Okay.
I don't mind.
This is Chris.
Hi, Dad. How you doing, sir? Cool. Can I steal him for the next half hour of intense physical rigorous activity? We're going to abuse him real good. Okay, is there anything important that you need for like the next hour or so? Probably not. Okay, it's cool. Alright, cool. Thank you, sir. See ya. Your dad's nice. I like him.
He is.
Tell Brian I said hi. Alright. You, come here. You, come here.
Into the mold house?
This pile, yeah, but there's a little bit of shit right here. These two things. And the bag, these three things, it's pretty obvious, go in the van. Wow, the smell in there is fun.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
I'm just in the back of the trailer, I don't know.
Yeah, you keep thinking that. We brought you because you big. The fact that you can drive just means that you got to back up the trailer. Because you get to do it in one try instead of watching Batman do it in 11.
Yeah, I did have a few pull-ups there. I was a little
disappointed. We would be here for about 4 hours watching me go up.
Yeah, that would have
two
sucked.
Two holes in the house. And
I get nothing, man.
Well, maybe what we can do is I'll just tear the door frame around it,
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah, we need to not fuck that up. That's a sailboat mast.
I'm trying not to, but it's kind of in my way.
I'll try my best to tear the door.
Can we pull it that way?
That's what we're trying to do. It's hooked on something back there.
Oh, shit. All right. Yeah.
It's sitting on a duct, but then there's another mast laying on top of it, so it needs
it's hooked on something.
Like this needs to
We can tear the door frame out around it.
All right. Yeah, because we're going to be under it with the machine, so it doesn't matter.
I think this is going to help.
You got a mast. You're okay. All right.
We need that window move.
Yep. We should take this little thing out. It'll be in the way later. We can move it right now while it's easy. Here, fuck fighter, hold the light. It's not on wheels.
No, I thought it was too. Shit. You're sitting on a big piece of foam. Casey, come grab
Casey, I need a couple big guys.
Casey and Minkus, though.
Casey and Minkus would do it just fine.
Okay. Minkus!
You have more mass?
What is it?
In the van.
Aziz! Light!
Don't breathe.
Yeah, hold the gun.
This is a gun sight, Mark 29.
Joe could help too, he's pretty beefy. Amy, come hold the light for me, please. I'm going to turn the door frame out gently. He wants it in one piece because he might use it. Look, spider covered in mold.
Alright, look out.
Hello, sir. You two gentlemen, take that, please. Okay. Pick up a toll base, everything.
So I'm gonna tear this off.
Hold up. All right. There we go. And go.
It goes right to the van. Thank you, gentlemen. Follow. I got one for you.
Okay.
Where's Minkus?
I don't know.
He's hiding.
He's getting his gear ready.
Okay, then you two gentlemen, are you using them on the door?
No, I'm trying to get the door apart.
You two gentlemen with me, please.
This is working so well.
Very, very carefully, please grab this piece of equipment and put it in the van.
Well, if it's aluminum, it looks heavy.
It probably is aluminum, actually.
I think it is.
It's for aviation use, so.
It's gonna be heavy. It's heavy. It's not too bad, though. Heavier than the other ones.
Yeah?
Oh, it's so heavy! Oh. I don't know, the other ones I was able to throw it over my shoulder, so I don't know about that one.
Alright.
Can we just... Yeah? Do you need to poop a little?
Yeah. Okay. Oh no, I was pooping. It's just... Gotta shake a few out.
It's really pretty.
Any chance we're gonna get any of this up and running?
Yes, actually. That's rather the point. There'll be some equipment autopsy happening, some restoration, we'll get to clean it all.
Cleaning.
Yeah, everything gets detail cleaned. Can you give these gentlemen a hand with this?
Yeah.
This
I
one's heavy.
Brought gloves. I don't know why I didn't put them on.
Careful, careful, careful.
Uh,
Cool. Okay, it's still safe. What you thinking, Gergie? Well, we're going to drop a lot of weight by taking the doors off it.
Oh, I'm not worried about that.
Oh, just getting that piece off? I trust your judgment.
I know, let's use fucking railroad nails as a fucking door.
How you doing, Batman?
Jesus.
Yeah?
I'm just going to use, you know, railroad ties as a fucking, a railroad nail.
Sounds
fucking.
Like everybody is far away.
We're muffled. All right. You guys come through here and start prepping, moving like the boat and shit. There's a piece of glass we need to move.
There's a room there. We got to figure out the easy way to get stuff in there. But let's start by moving this window. Okay, guys. The window, the ladder, the car door, the window, stuff, all needs to end up in that room. Now let's see how to get to that room. We got to go this way.
Not so much.
No, keep going.
Let's play a
walk around. Yeah, we got to fumble fuck around to get there. Is that the way?
That's the right way,
yeah. Okay. Is this the way? No. How the fuck do you get to that room? How the hell do you get to that room? I found it! Okay, so we go this way around.
Oh, fuck me.
Hey, David!
Yeah?
We found out how to get there. It's a lot easier. You go right through that door.
Bowden.
Yeah.
I love you.
Love you too.
I'm wearing the red shirt on this mission.
Yeah, you are.
Did you see that door there?
Yeah, I know.
That's got the bookcase.
Yes, we know.
Yeah.
All right, so we got to get that window, the ladder, all the big bulky shit comes out of there into here. So you're on that team.
Okay.
You're getting video of this process. Move this. This can go in there. Thank you, sir. What you doing?
Getting the winching system set up.
Okay.
You guys aren't ready for my muscle yet, are you?
I can use your muscle for one specific thing. I got a little thing you can move.
Oh, that is one weird ass house.
Yeah, the guy who lived here was a little kooky.
Hold it up like that.
Work with physics, Batman.
Jesus, they don't make these at Home Depot anymore.
Houses fall down before they get moldy now.
All right, Batman. There you go.
There you go. Work with physics.
If he had just taken that brick casing off on the outside, he could have just cut the nails.
All right, I'll show you what I need you to grab. Come this way, sir. Excuse me, Batman. I would have had it done by now if all these assholes were on the mic.
Oh, shut up.
That box right there. Thank you, sir.
You want to put that little thing right there?
No.
You're not getting blog of this?
I'm shooting on the eyepiece.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And I've got Theo running around with a camera.
Through with stuff.
I just want to get the door done.
Ammonium hydroxide, kerosene, nitric acid, distilled water. The basement's empty. I might have to check that out later. Spider, right there. Nope. Not going that way.
You know that.
Amy made a friend. Amy made a friend.
Oh, that must be his head over there.
That'd make it venom, wouldn't it?
Well, whatever.
You can wiggle.
So the toxicity of my pepper.
Yeah. I don't think it would kill you.
Do you know the difference between venomous and poisonous?
Do I care?
It's all about delivery
if
method.
If it bites you, it's venomous. If you eat it and get sick, it's poisonous.
Hey.
That's what? The system. It's all about who's biting who.
What if it spits at you? Poison.
You made a friend. We're going to put him on a leaf. They like leaves. They eat leaves. And then they pupate.
He was over here.
Well, let's make his day better. Let's take him out to the trees.
Yeah, instead of the moldy house.
Yeah. If he doesn't want to eat anything out of that house.
There's a
tree. See, that's a great place to be.
Oh, there's a spider web.
See, it's already a tree that's home to living things.
That was useful. He's dead now.
No, he's fine. So you made a friend.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
He's fuzzy.
I can breathe out of here.
Mm-hmm,
you can. Alright, are we ready?
I told you.
Let's do it!
Booy!
Let's go get a piece of gear.
We need the regular actual
angle. Oh, also, these don't work with
No, they don't. Hence the reason I'm not wearing
it. Is it moving yet?
We're still working on the fucking shelf.
Okay. I was like, I saw the box come out.
Right, but the shelf is still here.
Okay.
And it's there a little, the bolts are just a little worn.
All right, before we, I want to get it out to the garage. You're taking off side cabinets? All right.
What are you doing?
Huh?
What is that coming off for?
Because the side panels are, it's fucking battleship grade.
You take the side panels off, it should help the weight a lot. Plus it'll look really cool going down
the road. Hey Doogie, when you take off the side panels, take the bottom bolt off first.
Yeah. Well, it's held on with studs, so I didn't care in this case, but yes, I followed that procedure on that.
I like your sexy wrench.
That's mine.
Where do you get blue anodized wrenches?
Meyer.
Okay.
They're Stanleys.
Nice, so they'll stand up to at least 7 or 8 pounds of torque.
Right. Hey man,
is that off?
Yep.
All right.
I paid 20
watch
bucks
out.
For it. I just needed it.
Don't
to
do that yet. Hey Batman.
What?
Move.
All right.
I don't know how heavy that door is, but I'm guessing heavy. All right. Somebody lever it.
Batman, you.
Back there, up. Because if that pops down, I don't want landing on you.
Who's got the thingy?
Hold on.
Pry bar.
My tool bag. Oh, I had a little. Oh, shit, the little one's a time. Where did I leave the other one?
It's probably sitting on the stem, so if we lift it from the bottom. If it's heavy enough.
I need a big goddamn hammer, is what I need. Excuse me, sir. Give me a straight blade screwdriver.
Uh-huh.
Out of there.
Damn it, all tools have the same handle. Your choices is this.
Did we get it?
Yeah, it's done.
Here's a small one. Oh, I got a real tripod right here.
Oh, wait, here it comes.
That doesn't look very heavy.
No, it really doesn't.
It doesn't feel very heavy.
This might not be worth to take them off.
I don't know. Pop it off.
Well, we got to at least take this one off, dude. You went to the trouble.
Right.
It's aluminum. Well, it's aluminum. It doesn't weigh anything.
Not worth it. All right. Go put that one in the van.
Doogie!
Doogie! Don't worry about taking the other ones. They're too light to worry about.
Yeah, they don't weigh anything.
Why wouldn't we leave it on to protect components and travel?
We might, but we'll worry about it when we get it out.
Heaven forbid that a little bit more water gets in there.
Oh, if we want to get it working.
There's already been enough water in there.
In travel, it's not going to get wet, and the breeze blowing through it might actually get rid of some of the nasty.
Fair enough.
For the solid dials. It's amazing.
The thing of beauty.
It's absolutely amazing.
Synchro generator.
Made by GM. Oh, shit.
Born into
Well, back then.
And the money it must cost to make one or two of these. Keep in mind, this was made without computers. This is slide rule. Serial number 1972, made for Ford by Cornell Dublier.
No fucking way.
Right here.
Yep.
That's
Cornell Dublier.
Awesome. You need to send that to...
Yeah, send them one.
That's fucking awesome.
Here, hold the light. I'll get a picture.
Made for Ford.
That can't be done on the trailer.
Cornell Dublier. Well, Batman's still working, so...
I'm still working on the shelf. A bit of a bitch. Rudy, you still got that socket handy? I got a couple
It's right there. It's right in front of you.
Oh, man. Yeah.
to. Three more fucking bolts. Right. Aziz! Bigger than that. Oh, quarter inch, you better fucking fit.
Metric!
No. Wait a minute. Goddamn USA. Back when America meant something.
Hey, we won the war with this.
I know. Come on, give it back.
You know what you need? Ball end.
Yeah. I didn't realize that there were 8 bolts on the bottom as well. There's only 4, but still.
Yeah, but you knew it was all going to be socket head cap screws. Why didn't you bring the good ones?
These are the good ones, up the way.
It's ruining the happiness.
Right.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you, Chris.
Thanks, Chris.
Amy wanted the spray bottle to take it off. So I'm like, all right. Here, you get the spray bottle.
Thank you.
Get around, shoot from the backside.
Looks like you're giving birth. Back up, we gotta get a little. 1, 2, 3, go!
For this.
What?
We're missing a Bellatini.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, he would have fucking just thrown it over his shoulder.
Yeah, it'd be on the trailer by now.
Yeah, man. You need to be in the picture.
Other side.
Where do you want it at?
Out there.
Probably right where the Doogie might be. You can see the middle wheel.
Oh yeah.
Hold on.
Yeah, we need some more bodies in front
of this if that lets go. Yeah. We got
the
strap around it. That's
it. Yeah, but
that's
only going to
do
so much.
Me and Casey. 2. We're fine.
You want me to come help?
No, I want you back out of the way.
Yeah, we have no problems. I'm getting out of the way.
Yep.
That's a rule.
Here, you can do that.
The tree will stop it just fine.
Not ready.
Do you want a moment to get ready? Here, secure your shed.
Okay.
It's pushing the plywood. Okay, it's on, it's rolling. Hold on.
Okay, leave the grass tomorrow.
Alright.
You hit the concrete anyway. Alright. Okay.
You ready?
This thing is so immensely heavy. I'm really worried that we have any control over it at all.
Alright.
Where are we going? Alright, the last leg needs to get up. It's flat up against the plywood. Mm-hmm. We're gonna need the Johnson start to fire back on this thing.
This is it.
push this end over that way.
Yep.
It's going. Okay. It is indeed going. It went.
Watch your toes.
Alright, if we can stop it here and advance the plywood.
Switch the two
boards.
Well,
we can get off the plywood and onto the concrete to be fine.
Okay.
Right? Nothing about the sound of plywood isn't doing all that much anyway.
Right. It's stopping us from sinking.
Okay.
All right, now the lawn's going to be ridiculous.
Now we have
you need more plywood.
But we need plenty of bodies for brakes.
Don't run away. It's all right. Casey and I have got some good motion together.
Lineman.
Oh. I don't even think you're doing anything, dude.
Oh, okay.
You could help with the plywood, though.
All right, got it.
Well, if they're on that little lift on the trailer,
they're not gonna work at all.
Right, hey Minkus.
What?
Those ramps have gotta be more up on that.
I know.
Okay. Is that they'll just slide right off that?
I know this. Okay. I just got them there for right now.
All
right. How are we doing? Ready?
We need the other.
You want to be over there?
Actually, we need some stabilization back here. Yeah.
That 10,000 pieces and there's nothing to grab. Hey, look, big handle.
I think
that plywood
if we
slip back.
Levered this up with that pry bar again.
Yeah.
So we get the Johnson.
Johnson! Johnson, get your tool over here!
It's good to know.
Hey, Minkus! Part right here still turns.
Yeah, this one does.
Okay, we're ready?
Yep. You okay? Stupid OSB. Whose idea was it to bring OSB? Damn it.
Oh, I had, goddamn.
Yeah, let's get some $200 a sheet marine grade.
Do we have another piece for right here so we can.
Yeah,
we got the other pieces.
If I'd known what we were doing,
yeah,
I could have brought the sign plywood I've got.
So right now, Casey, you're just playing one hell of a tug of war.
I know. I'm okay with this.
Yeah, but I'm winning.
So we're rotating it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Clockwise.
Come forward.
Counterclockwise.
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, yeah.
Give me a trip.
What are we hanging on?
There you get your Johnson in there and move it.
You're making me giggle while we're moving shit. Alright, one more time, Juju. Get your Johnson in there.
Stick it between the legs.
Alright, this is the terrifying part. This is the part where the wrap breaks down.
Well, this is the part where the winch gets to help us, right?
Yeah. We're doing this for science.
Okay.
We're kind of an Ed Brunswick.
It's either that or the
Johnson. Everybody let go. I didn't.
No, well,
it's not. It's more or less on level.
Checkpoint reached.
Here.
I need.
We're drifting.
Hold on. Yeah, I know we're drifting.
He could feel he was holding it.
Throw this under the wheel, casters on this side. That's why I said I was the only one.
Let go.
Okay.
Alright, we're cool. Alright, because we're going to need this to hook it to.
Well, I got another one too, but.
Well, rotate so that his hooks are facing. But no, we want to go around it.
Yeah.
Yes. Cradle it. Go under
the ball. Go under this. Grab your tools off of it.
scratch and scratch.
I didn't.
It's actually fairly large. For being claustrophobic.
Wow, that's
great. Now it's out of calibration.
That's quite the come along. Oh, that's a jack.
Yeah.
I see what you're doing.
You know what? That's totally science-y. Amy, you don't want to be standing there.
It's totally four-wheel drivey.
So,
alright, what's happening, yo?
I guess it is.
Very, very slow.
Okay, with this.
Casey, if you put a foot on this beam, make sure it keeps.
Somebody straight. Needs to be on the front end down here pushing hard because it's pulling that way.
Alright. Whoa, hey, too much.
Let's get the middle of the ramps lined up with the wheels. Casey, yours has to go towards you.
I can.
Towards me?
The ramp. Mm-hmm. The ramp.
Okay.
All right, that'll do.
That'll do, don't hate me.
That'll do.
Yeah, put a foot right on it.
And you just wanted to do this with me and Dave in the van.
I might need to use the Johnson bar to help get the wheels off the lift. This is range of 7,000 pounds.
Ooh,
We're on the ramp.
Hey,
and the bar is good for 500 pounds. Watch your toesies, kids. Toesies.
Hey, Joe. Be anywhere but where you are.
And also keep your feet underneath the machine.
I was going to stop it if it broke.
Yep, if you were going to do that. You were going to break
it.
What a hero.
It won't be long and we're going to need to have that.
Back end toward me.
Front end toward Casey.
Yeah.
Toward Casey?
Yeah.
We're fine.
We're drifting towards Batman a little bit.
Well, because the back end is going out. That's why I told him push on the back corner. Towards us.
All right, keep going.
Thank you. Excellent. That's better.
All right, we need to put that block under those wheels. Make sure it doesn't move. Cause I got to reset.
To tighten up on that.
You can't get another foot before you do that.
You can start running this up. Out. This'll.
Oh. Okay.
Well, it's Johnson.
We're fine. Don't put any pressure on it, you're fine. Don't forget we can put the sailboats back.
Shut up.
We are not even halfway through here.
Alright.
Shut the fuck up.
Nice and easy as we're coming off those 2x though. Because those ramps are going to want to pop right up.
Yep.
Yeah, but there's wheels that the ramps will hit. Right. Up. But I just want to make sure because they're small casters, they don't.
There's one. And the trailer starts taking weight.
More guys back on in, this side. Back in. Bye, Casey.
All right. Crunch it. Here goes the other side.
There we go.
All right.
And we're level again.
Okay. All right. Do we have to reset again?
No, we got
a great time to reset.
We got another foot. Yeah, but if we reset now, we're only going to get half a pull on the next one.
Okay. All right, waist back in the ramp. Pressure on your side towards us?
Yeah, I got to get front end, yep. Keep the wheels straight. There we go. You can keep the wheels nice and straight.
Possibility when this next set of wheels goes, these ramps are going to fall off entirely.
At that point, we won't need them.
Yeah, exactly. So, just letting everybody know.
Okay.
Shouldn't there still be weight on the back to hold it in place?
That'd be alright.
Actually, we may need to reset before that happens.
That'll be a bit.
Nah,
it's alright.
Alright, chuck it!
Can you do it?
Best you can. Even if you gotta put them under the front ones up here.
I got a ratchet strap. You can take the slat right over this and that allows you to...
We should be alright.
We're okay. We're okay. Good.
They said they got it right now.
Just enough pressure to keep it.
Okay.
Oh yeah, that's fucking great.
Wait.
Someone put up.
Come a little more. You guys got it?
Oh, that caster's been facing the wrong way this entire time.
We can bring that up and should be able to hopefully get enough to anchor it up top.
Up top.
All right, well, see what you got.
No hurry.
All of my life. Nope. I'll get you to here. No.
Wood.
That'll suck, but...
I'm gonna go 20 or just lay your way
home. I can put on that.
I want off to you.
Doogie, you ever do transmission work on the side of the road?
Yes. Good thing I got my Stanley sockets then. For metric data. It says it's built for, you know, automotive, even though the spark plug socket hasn't fit on anything I've ever done.
This is set. Take.
I got about a foot of slack.
That's not bad, Mr. Clark.
That's a whole lot of slack.
Yeah. It's all right. We'll get there.
Worst case scenario.
Be after this pull though, so let's get what we can on this one. Because then we'll swap that for the chain and fold it and pull.
Set that in there.
Yeah. Well, you know what we do?
Oh, actually,
slack it. Slack it. Yeah, let me put a clevis in there. Guys, hold it. Catch it.
Oh, yeah, easily said.
Get in there and I'll pull.
This is going quickly, so you know.
Set it.
You never see a Batman. You never see a Batman, Ben. It's not pleasant.
The thing that told
take.
Oh,
that's way more better. I like that.
I'm glad you like it. You take the weight off of it.
There it goes.
We get a quarter stroke. This is going to be awesome.
I was on the crew team, leave me alone.
Give me the free end. Put the set end up here. We'll put the free end down there.
Free end.
Got it?
I was just thinking cradle hook.
No, he'll just put it in the shackle.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense too.
Hold it. Hold it in.
Oh, we're not quite there yet, are we?
No, you gotta take up a bunch of
slack. Give me the end of that.
You got a lot of slack. Handed the ball. Hey, how's it? I could.
You good?
Yep, you're set. Fuck.
You didn't even touch anything.
Because this is like a theoretical hole with the legs.
That's where that engaged.
And the slack goes.
Alright, it's holding.
What are you eyeing? Just looking at this hook. Okay.
Just watch that hook.
Just watching that hook. It's not bending at all.
Sorry, right, it's 20,000 pounds.
It's the hook ain't bent. I just need the hook to stay there. Alright. So you wanna slip through the choke ends? Get your hand out of there.
Can you hook to the van or the trailer yet?
Pulling pin.
Yep, the grab hooks right there.
You get there.
When this gets all whirly and burly and
pin set. Hook set, go. Yes, Casey, on Batman's got about 3-4 inches.
Okay, so this is going to drop on my side. Got
yes.
It.
Yep.
It's probably not going to drop, Casey. It's just going to keep rolling because the back wheel's smart.
Cool.
It's flying.
I love how that is like on by like a, what, half an inch on that lip.
That's all you need.
All you need is love.
All you need is a half inch of ground clearance.
How is that thing like 5 feet and we're only getting like 3 inches at a time?
Look at the space in between the holes.
No, I'm just talking about like every time I feel like we reset it, we only move like.
It's because this is cut in half by that.
Kept rigging. Science, goddammit.
Motherfucking physics.
There you go.
About falling in a hole.
She was gracefully.
The battery's dead.
Oh.
Here, stop recording. All right, you're good there.
Am I done?
You're recording.
I'm done!
Oh, we are. It's all
right. All right, I gotta go.
Okay.
I gotta be back in town in 15 minutes.
All right, you should be all right.
All right.
That's about how long it'll take, a little bit longer now.
But I'm gonna leave Amy with the camera. You want to stay or do you want to ride with me? Can you ride with them? Be cool?
You can ride with them. Room in your car.
Kind of.
All right. Kind of. So I'm gonna leave both them with the camera so I can get it for the blog.
Well, if you don't want to burden his, I can put it back with you.
How does that help?
Because I need to go back too.
Oh. I'm not going to the lab, was my thing. If I don't have to take him, I don't have to go to the lab. I can go straight to the thing.
Wheel comes over.
This really sucks. I want to be here for this, but
all right.
I have to be in town in, 12 minutes. You should go.
So run, motherfucker.
This is cool.
We got control over the situation, at least. All right,
you guys got this?
We got it, boss.
All right, Theo's in charge. Your ass, okay? You're in charge. All this. It's all you. Okay.
If anything breaks, it's your fault.
Anything goes wrong, it's the new intern's fault. There's a lot of trust in this trailer that we've never done anything like that. No, that's some pretty heavy steel on the top.
It's C-channel, and look at the quarter-inch plate.
Yeah.
Or angle on the edge.
I've already had to replace a window on this van, getting the same exact kind of shit from the same exact house. I don't want to have to do it again. Lewis, can you get into the van and dig out all the other yellow ratchet straps, the ones that gets up there, and tie it down quick? They're probably going to be on the side door. There should be like two more, three more, something like that. It's harder to...
Yeah.
Do we want to leave this... Doogie, do we want to put this up front or leave it more over the axles?
Probably the axles. Because that's going to put a lot of tongue weight on it.
Well, I think we need just a little bit of tongue weight.
Well, yeah, but...
So just above.
If you put the center right in line with the front of the wheel fenders.
Yeah, if we can get it so I can have the center strap on that first bracket so I can strap it.
That'd be good.
Strapping, it's going to be a beast. I can for sure get one right through the middle, but the other two, I don't know.
Oh, we're almost there. This thing's like way slack right now.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
On the trailer.
Oh, two of the wheels are on the trailer. Let's just give a push. Can we give a push?
Yeah, just push.
Holy cow. Okay.
All right. Can you chalk it? Or we still got more to go?
I think we need to come forward a couple feet.
Well, I'm just saying for now, I can get everything out of the way so we can get exactly where we want.
Yeah, chalk it up.
Oh, sorry. Get everything out of the way.
Try it, Batman!
Ratchet,
I don't want to fall in the hole.
What?
Ratchet straps are at hand. Yes,
center of it's going to be right where the shackle lock, the U-bolt.
Yeah.
Where the steak pockets are.
Steak pockets?
Yeah, that's what it's called.
Hot pockets. I just put steak in my pockets.
Right
about there.
Yes.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Base track. Stop. You're talking center of balance. We still have the giant calculator to put on. It's going to go up front.
Yeah, I can just sit.
Well, whatever. Six one way or the other. Six one way that doesn't matter.
Don't want it on the bolts, I'll get past the bolts.
You want to start it this way? How off is it?
Batman? Do it this way.
Actually,
we're
going
to use this
the,
as our
front.
They're not in my fucking strap.
Well, no, it's a pretty. I put it there.
Shh.
Lewis,
it's
not
a knot.
It's sort of causing an accident on the highway from people trying to figure out what this is.
It's a good thing I'm not going on the highway.
It's a thing.
That's a good thing.
Hey, Batman. When you go back. You know that double set of lights. Once you're after after 21 splits and then comes back.
There we go.
And then you set a light. You're good now. Put that second light. Turn right. Let it be lighter. You can take it all the way back.
Go ahead and start right.
I've been looking for this, put it in my flat, but I can't friggin' find it.
Yeah, just go ahead and put that in the bin, because...
You want to know the funny thing?
Huh?
Put it on the Amazon wishlist. Actually, not the Amazon wishlist. They're expensive on Amazon. I got this for $70 from Summit Racing.
Okay.
It's the all cast iron one, so... Versus the stamp sheet metal one. And you can buy the 48-inch version of this at
so
Tractor Supply
one more in the
for
middle.
80.
Cool
just
story,
straight
bro.
Down.
Hand me the last stretch strap. We're gonna go straight down, right in the middle. Steak pockets.
Steak pockets.
A motherfucker left before he could buy pizza.
It's like Hot Pockets, only with steak.
Diarrhea pockets.
Hey, you want the wrench on the exact right side?
It's only on the right side if you're facing
that
way.
We're going right to the steak pocket right in front of the wheel. We're going to go over. What are you doing? Hand it to Casey.
Give it to someone who knows.
Well, you were obviously doing it.
Right, I'm definitely slacking off.
Wasn't that obvious?
Wouldn't it have been fun if I had to
do I've done worse.
I know.
So, your Mazda's really insured, right?
Yeah, why?
Sorry, he knows how to get back now.
You're the guy behind us, right?
So, let me ask you this, Batman. How would you like to have done it in one of these?
I have an actual terminal.
You have it in the truck van?
Huh? Not right now, but I would have
grabbed it. You told me before we left that you had a bunch of shit, so I was like, oh, fuck it. I won't bring mine in.
I gotta drag this dirty thing out of the seat.
Alright.
Oh, great. Now it's on. Now it's just stuck at the switch.
Oh, no, we're all gonna die!
No, we like that some ICBM silo somewhere in Utah just opens up and fires.
Hey, they're converting those to high-end condos now.
Yeah, I heard that.
Casey,
it's like David, a valve to regulate Lewis, the electrons.
Grab the calculator, put it right up front.
We're going this way.
Yes, go, go.
Doogie and Amy, get away from that side. They're going to come in through there.
Fuck me, running. Batman, no.
If we had, like, a cart.
If you brought the fucking Palajack.
Don't you have all those straps? Can't you move it like a piano? With straps?
Does it have wheels? What are we gonna, are you just going to drag across the ground?
Well, no. Like, you put a strap under each end and you lift, like, the moving straps.
It's military grade.
Here's an idea.
What about sticking both of these through?
No, no, no.
Like forks and the people on either side.
You got that high
lift jack. I'm going to
bend his high lift jack.
Here's an idea. I know nobody wants to really try that right now. It's out here. You can always come back to the van and a few people will put it to the van.
We got that on camera. Your confession.
Knock it over, Lewis.
What?
Knock it over.
Roll it.
It's not, it won't even roll.
All right, we'll
it's
come.
It's called the principle of leverage. The other way.
The other way down the hill. Yeah, towards the garden. We'll come back around.
Yeah, through the trees.
We've got a wheelbarrow. We're good. Someone put the wheelbarrow down at the bottom of the hill.
It'll catch it.
We can bring the crane.
What? Oh, Joe's got it. Look at that.
Nope, that's not going to happen. Boys, go ahead.
He's going to roll it on his own.
We could, like,
if we had, like, two people, maybe.
Signed away
that, is too, that is too heavy, dude.
About 2,000 pounds.
Alright. Well, here's the good thing. Both Casey and I just tried it. The biggest, tightest motherfuckers we got. And it didn't move. We'll come back with the crane.
Crane and atlas.
Alright, get the freaking, get the wood loaded up. Get the pry bar out of there.
We gotta get the trailer from the boat back.
We gotta get the one boat back over there for sure. In the garage. Who has my black flashlight? Thank you.
Who's got black
to start lock. Oh, we gotta get there.
Right. Where is this
wood
going?
Wood can go into the van.
Into the van.
Yeah, throw it on top of everything.
Carefully.
Carefully, gently.
Definitely don't throw it on top of that one glass dome.
Right.
So you're gonna take a video of it on the road?
If you want to sit in the back of the van with all the shit and sit there.
No,
out
I
the
have
window.
My car.
Well, give the camera to someone who's riding with Casey and they can take a video of it while he's going down the road.
That's fine.
Alright.
There's the MC.
I'm shutting it down for right now.
That's fine.
Oh boy. Nice and
slow. It made everything better.
Oh god.
Yeah. Those are good sounds. I like how the wheels don't have brakes on them.
They wouldn't do much.
It makes me feel better.
There's like a central caster in there. I didn't even know that.
Yeah, new deal.
Eh. Okay. Right into the sun.
Okay. Getting some great video.
This video was excellent.
Except people are gonna be like, "The sound bad, man, cause you're hanging out the car." Yeah, we got a mute button. What you listening to for anyway?
Did y'all see that dude in a wheelchair fall from the sky?
What? I'm sorry, what?
There's a dude falling from the sky in a wheelchair. He's connected to a parachute.
I don't think it's a wheelchair. I think that's a... Isn't that one of those fan things that keep you going?
I'm driving.
Yeah, what is that?
I have
no idea what the fuck he's talking about.
It must be behind us.
No, it's up here. It's
I thought you had a mask on when you were in the mold there.
I think he's got one of those fans that keep him going.
When I went through to lock up the house, I ate a couple mushrooms on the way out.
Yeah, it's not any good for the blood camera, but yeah, there's a guy in a thing with a thing.
We've identified a man in the air with a thing.
We not only have bad video, but bad descriptions as well.
There's a person in a location with an object performing an action.
It's like I'm there.
We've identified it as existing in both space and time.
We can stop when we're not going downhill.
10-4, that's good to know. Stop.
Yeah, we got that sun just right in front of us.
Yeah, we can go ahead and shut that off.
No, I'm keeping it.
Oh, good, good. Hey, my registration.
Inquiring.
Don't video that.
Inquiring minds. Your registration? In the glove box there?
So if you get pulled over, you'd look for it in the glove box and not find it?
Yeah, probably.
No, I have it up. So the man on the radio said that gas might get down to under $3.
What?
He's full of crap.
Jeez, I almost missed the fear-mongering.
Man on the radio is lying. Because the price of fuel never goes down coming up on winter.
You'd think they'd bring it way up and blame it on ISIS or something. Even though it makes no logical sense.
It makes complete logical sense to use absolutely any reason to jack up oil prices. To them. We would like to sell this for more.
Are you saying that BP controls hurricanes?
That's what all those chemtrails are, man.
I knew it. The Batman does know how to use brakes, so there's a ground fault in the trailer at the moment.
Yeah, I'm guessing. This is just the right blinker, isn't it? This would be a great weekend to go camping. The weather's perfect, it's not gonna rain.
Yeah.
It's all downhill from here.
2 weeks from now we're gonna have 4 feet of snow.
Right?
In half an hour, just one night. Gonna stop into a Subway real quick, come out, your car's just gonna be gone.
Yeah, you'll have had your windows down with
the
snow drift in it.
$5 foot long was not worth it.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, I mean, that's some good value. That sub.
The depths of my hunger know no bounds.
My apologies, vlog, for the dirty windshield. I hit a lot of bugs on the way out. Hit the brakes. brakes, Batman.
Brakes, Batman, brakes!
Nope. So, I don't know.
Sorry, there's no stopping there, but it's okay. Just take this road straight, you'll hit Grand Rapids. I'm also going to drive like 10 under the speed limit so you can catch up.
That's fine. If I hit the lake, I know I'd gone too far.
Ooh, lens flares.
Oh, I was about to be like, inappropriate, Stan.
No,
they're like 12.
I tilted the camera down for a reason, and then I noticed the lens flares. See, and they won't know what we're laughing about because I didn't show the people. So yeah, at this point the blog's pretty unnecessary, but it's not like we're wasting tape. Just stare out at the picturesque West Michigan landscape. Need more shots with lens flares.
It's a really good video. Someone riding on the trailer just holding onto one of the straps.
Yes.
I would have done it.
That's why we mentioned it after we left.
Yeah.
So you wouldn't do it.
There's a nice lens flare.
Ooh,
just the little red dots. I'm for it.
No one knows what I'm laughing at, but Lewis has his head out the window.
Does he?
This makes total sense. That only works when you have sunglasses on.
And when you have your mouth closed. Trees. It's early autumn in West Michigan, and the leaves are just starting to change.
Do you guys ever, I mean, obviously no one was old enough to get them when they were happening, but there were those old Disney-produced, like, kind of nature documentaries, but they were, like, from around the world. I feel like it was, like, the 70s they had a lot of them. I don't know, there was one where, Walt Disney, I know, was, like, really obsessed with, Central America. So he had, like, a tour of Central American countries, and it was all just, hey, this is what people in the parts of the world have never seen do. Like, here's Panama, and here's Guatemala, and
seen it.
There was some interesting live action stuff they did in the 70s. It's interesting.
Excellent.
If I zoom the camera in.
I feel like when I was in daycare, we had very outdated media. So we were like, here, watch this. It's not from the 80s, it's from the 70s. Oh well.
Maybe someday we'll make it to the moon. You just had a whole bunch of duck and cover videos to watch? Hey there, Billy! You afraid of the Red Scare? That's why it's called the Red Scare.
I love the things you can find on YouTube. Like, I don't know how I found it, but I found an interview with Michael Jackson just after he had left the Jackson 5, and he was talking about his, like, starting solo career. And he was still very humble, but he was putting out, like, ridiculously good music. And it was just so interesting.
There was an...
I know there was some sad bastard in the 80s who was like, I'm going to record this, sit on it for 30 years, convert it to digital, and upload it. It's like, thank you, sad man. That was interesting. I don't know if it was worth your time, but it was interesting.
There was an article a while ago, maybe about a year ago now, that was, someone found Michael Jackson's original manifesto in his storage, and it was him talking about all the crazy things he was going to do to become the most famous pop star ever. And it made a lot of sense.
Well, hell, the last thing he did was the giant M robot that was gonna walk around Las Vegas promoting his show.
Was that a thing?
Yeah! He was going to make a giant him robot that just wandered around in the desert like, woo, Michael Jackson, come see my show. I mean, you can't really, I don't know, you can mock him for living in his fantasy land, but, I mean, if he really believed all that stuff, man, that must have been a cool way to live. When you've got so much money that you're just like, build a robot of me. Okay.
You have a zoo in your backyard, yeah. And yeah, I mean,
that's how I would be unseemly rich. You know, just with a deeper voice.
Well, you know, they had him on like rhino tranquilizers all the time.
Yeah.
Henry Ford was like that. He bought, I forget how many tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of acres in South America. He was going to build, like, mastermind a utopia. He did that. They had armed thugs at some of the plants keeping the workers working. And they'd go to your home and, like, see if you were drinking too much or your house wasn't clean enough or whatever.
Wasn't there the Pinkertons? That was the big thing with them? It was like a detective agency. It was union busters and just general like thugs for hire. Like they called themselves a detective agency, but there was mostly like, hey, rough people up for me.
Yeah.
Here's a legitimate business to say you do.
Yeah, there was a lot of that before the labor unions. And Henry Ford started out trying to make livable wage and an affordable car for the working guy, and throughout his career, I mean, he turned into a maniacal bastard.
Yeah.
Mr. Ford, speaking of Ford, will you get the fuck out of the way?
Yeah!
Thank you.
Alright, now I can do the
excellent
zoom.
Excellent segue there. Speaking of Ford, fuck off!
I think when you got so much money, your job is to just sit around and dream up what you can do with your money.
Well, see, that's the thing. Is like, I feel like there's two types of people. There are people that are like, their job becomes sitting around thinking about how they're going to spend all their money. And there are other people that are like, sitting around thinking about how they're going to grow all their money. Like, oh man. There are some people who cannot imagine ever being like, what if I spent it all and then I was poor again? Be poor on a yacht. Better than I am.
Wonder how many comments this video is going to get for all the zooming in and out I'm doing.
All of the comments.
All the comments. It's going to be like a 4-hour blog today. Fucking Joe, the goddamn zooms.
What I really hope is this becomes like the opening scene to a found video, a found footage horror film, you know?
Yeah. And it goes kind of not chronologically.
Yeah, it's terrible.
Like, it's like, wait a second. This movie starts with them moving a computer, and then now they're getting hacked. I don't get it. Why, that's a weird setup.
It's a computer, but it's just full of gears. I don't get it at all.
You know, for as much shit as Chris gives me about my camera handling, I got better camera handling than those people did. Freaking Cloverfield. That's the monster! Let's just shake the camera forever.
Well, you can chalk that up to, like, actually trembling at a giant monster that's right there.
Man,
then
don't even worry about the camera. If you're that worried about it,
get the shot no matter what.
That's what I'd do. I mean,
see, you know, you
it'd
really
still be
do,
a bad shot.
You know what you really need to do is you need to like, get a sponsorship from GoPro and then just have like all your like characters be like, hey, let's go to Best Buy and try out these GoPros. Oh, the world's ending! And then you've got, like, you know, like, nice POV footage, and you've got, you know, GoPro funding your video, and, you know.
Well, they got around that a little bit in one of the vignettes in VHS 2, where the guy gets a bionic eye that, like, makes him see ghosts and shit. So, like, the whole thing is through, like, super POV, because it's just his eyeball. And then I think another one in that movie was, like, a zombie with a GoPro helmet. Because it was, like, a guy on a bike, and then he got bit by a zombie, so he became a zombie with a GoPro on his head.
Nice.
Yeah. Like you do.
Like, yeah, yeah, like you do. I don't know, I thought, what was that, superpower movie? That was all found footage.
Chronicle.
That was actually, like, one of my favorite found footage kind of videos. Like, I mean, there were a lot of like plot holes as to like how people put up with him filming so often, you know?
Yeah.
Like, and, like, as anyone who's like tried filming people, the first thing that happens when you turn a camera on someone who's not ready for it, they just kind of wander away from you like, yeah, I'm not gonna let you do that.
Yeah. Well, that was like a third of the dialogue in the Blair Witch Project. Why do you still have the camera out? Because we're making a movie!
Every other line in Paranormal Activity, turn the camera off.
Probably. It's like, hey guys, just in case you didn't know, this is a found footage movie.
I feel like they could do House of Leaves as a found footage movie, seeing as the book was kind of about Navidson setting up, like, wiring his entire house with video to kind of record his family for a documentary, and then like the house was crazy, so like, I don't know, it was a book written almost intending to be made into a movie, simply because the book talks so much about all the cameras.
I'm sure no one's ever done that.
Well, it seems like a writer would like not worry so much about having so much. It's a found footage book, which is weird, because it's all what somebody had gotten off of these tapes and had written down.
It's like someone hoped to make a movie and make some money.
Maybe. It was one of those layers upon layers books where, like,
yeah, I started it.
Yeah, because like it's the tattoo artist who's collecting the crazy stuff that the Russian guy wrote down about the movie that didn't exist. Yeah, it was weird. Like the narration is like four steps removed from the actual plot.
It's a weird one.
I didn't finish it, so. Well, I mean, it starts to be just crazy, like, cuttings from newspapers and stuff, and it's like, yeah, if I was really in the mood for this, maybe, but.
What people need to do with a found footage film, and they probably haven't, because it would piss people off, but they need to do it where they actually change the aspect ratio. Because in Chronicle, there was, like, footage from security cameras and, like, people taking video on their iPhone, but it was still, like, 1:2, whatever, like, cinematic. But if someone was actually taking video from a iPhone that was, like, not sideways, it would be in that weird aspect ratio.
I paid for the full screen, damn it.
Well, plus they'd be at different frame rates, and, like, the security camera stuff would be, like, or ridiculously low. You know how they have those security tapes where they will have four tapes, four cameras all recording under the same tape, and then every fourth frame will be like the one camera.
Yeah.
And so like you have a certain player that like only plays that frame if you want to play it back, and you get really shitty video quality, but you don't have to change your tapes as often. So having some of those old outdated VHS. Oh gosh. If you've ever watched one of those security tapes where it's not editing out the other three frames, it is a weird thing to be looking at.
I've not done that.
It kind of makes you sick.
Yeah, I bet.
Your eye tries to focus on four different angles.
There was a movie like that. What was it? It was an independent film. Four people.
Four rooms?
No. It was four blocks of the screen all at the same time, and they interacted with each other at different parts of the day, and it's like time code or something.
Yeah, I've seen that. I think.
Hmm.
Am I the only one staring at those casters to see if they twist?
No. Yes.
I'm watching through the video because it's not as detailed as
not
the.
Yet.
Yeah, I wondered about that. If they could twist.
You got it pretty well strapped down. I got good reflexes. Fine.
It would have been nice if we could have gotten them off the casters.
No.
Once it was on the trailer. Like onto some pallets? That way we could just unload it with the forks?
We're gonna unload it with the forks anyway.
It wouldn't be strapped down on wheels. We'd use the friction. An AV intern for school? You're interning? You, yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
Yes. I'm primarily audio. I was doing it, well, I mean, I did it, I didn't need to get any credits or anything. I kind of did it more for experience than for school.
What exactly the phone fuck are you doing?
What am I doing?
No, not you. Her.
Her?
She's trying to get back in this lane.
No.
That ain't gonna happen.
Not here.
She's like, but I don't want to turn.
So yeah, my internship is technically up. I just keep showing up. Because they haven't told me to leave yet.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure when my internship will be up. Probably when I can't stand y'all anymore.
Yeah. Sounds good.
Basically here till someone will give me a job that pays me.
Yeah.
You got time.
You might as well be doing something with it. Yeah.
That at least gives me 40 hours a week of work.
I guess you can count the continued internship is a no gap in employment.
Yep, that's pretty much the. I mean, I'm working at a TV station now. They just give me like 10 hours a week.
Which TV station?
WGVU.
I had a friend who worked camera at Fox.
Damn it, man.
Same light, too, right?
Yes, it is the same light.
Womp womp.
Same light and everything.
Can't actually see the light.
I gotcha. I got it on camera.
We can check later.
There we go,
screen.
And T-bone.
Womp womp.
That'll be how our phone footage movie ends. we'll all be dead and the It'll like fade out on the
like,
red light.
Oh, it was red.
Oh, yes.
Worst found footage video ever.
Yeah. Won't even be a horror movie. It'll be a car accident movie.
Just
we'll invent a new genre.
Crash 2.
Oh God, Crash.
Electric Boogaloo. The recrashing.
Yes.
Yellow tree.
Crash harder.
Talk about crash.
Let's just hit every red light.
Yep. So where are we going again?
You know where you are, yeah?
Nope.
Well, anytime you want, you can kind of turn right.
Okay.
And we'll get to Leonard, and then you can take Leonard in.
Okay.
Like, well, not anytime you want. Most of the, most of the lights.
Not right now.
Most of the lights will get you. Like, technically, if you followed this right here, this SUV. Nope, you're not going to. That's Lakeside. That'd get you to Leonard.
Okay.
And actually, that'd get you to Michigan.
I'm in Michigan.
For now.
Stay on this road and you'll be in Lake Michigan.
And then keep going from there and you'll be in Wisconsin. my eyes.
That's all eyes.
Jeez. This is like the Star Trek reboot.
Oh god, I hate them so much.
There's just so much lens flare, you can't even see what's going on in the frame. It's just like, oh, this jet's white now. Alright, that's fine.
Okay.
It's like, I get it, JJ, I'm on a spaceship! I get it!
Made entirely of chrome.
It's the future! I understand, guys, come on!
Close up to Spock's chin and lens flare.
This is what the original series would have looked like if they didn't have terrible video that it was shot on. Chrome everything. It was the 50s or 60s.
The new song by Kendrick Lamar. All chrome everything.
Guy looks sad.
Did look sad.
Contemplating.
Buses.
Man, why? But why is bus?
I can answer that.
I don't know.
I can answer why is bus.
Why is bus?
Because people go place.
Oh!
Man, that looks greenish.
Green enough.
I don't smell bacon.
I actually do, but that's because I got a couple slices in my pocket.
I was referring...
Always.
Just always. The bacon reserve.
We should show up to, like, Goodwill or something with that computer and be like, you guys want this?
It can play my
show up the Best Buy at the Geek Squad. Can you fix this?
Is this under warranty? I think I got the extended warranty.
Oh, is this the Fuller that I could have turned on?
Yeah, that's the way we came.
Okay.
Oh, what, you too good for Lakeside, Fuller?
Fuck, I don't know.
Too good for Lakeside?
I keep forgetting you're from Indiana. I just kind of want to be like,
yeah.
I'm like Main Streets. Come on, man.
I'm from Indiana. I do not know Grand Rapids.
Oh, this is that Fuller Street. Yes, quaint. Four lanes, interesting.
Back in my land.
Where are the buggy hitches?
Because apparently Indiana is hyper primitive.
It's a century oil tycoon.
I drink your milkshake.
There's more than corn in Indiana.
There's oil!
Soy, too.
Yeah, exactly.
Soy!
Lots and lots of soy.
Grows lower to the ground.
Yes. Most plants generally grow on the ground.
But I mean, you know, don't get as tall. Whatever.
Gotcha. Best walk ever.
best what?
Blog.
Ah.
Well, now that I like go here, I don't watch the blogs anymore, so it doesn't bother me.
So I told Chris I fast forward through the blogs. Why? Because I'm freaking there.
You watched that entire Car Smash blog again.
I did, because it's awesome.
Like, we were there smacking on the car, and then afterwards we sat down and watched us smack on the car. It was fun when Chris dropped the car off the forklift. That was
my favorite part.
That was pretty good.
When we smacked the car.
I was definitely not there for that.
You should watch the blog.
I'm always amazed when, like, things don't get, like, wrecked by the antics. Like, those forks, I never thought that they'd hold up to all that, but, eh. It's short forks.
So,
it's a very smooth road.
They just made it.
I agree. I still agree. Man, look at that building. That's a
Michigan Blood Center.
It's a modern marvel, modern architecture there. Marvel of modern, not a modern marvel. Well, modern say, marvel
you
is.
You can't say modern anymore.
Can I not?
No, because modern means something.
Yeah. Okay.
You have
but
to say contemporary.
No, I wasn't meaning it in terms of genre. But I suppose you're right. Because we're post-postmodern now.
Yeah. Ironic post-postmodern. That's what we are.
Mortem.
We're pre-post-ironic post-modern.
That,
Art Deco. Surrealism. I want to get a t-shirt that says, "Talk to me about vorticism." It's a subgenre of, like, cubism that lasted for one art show.
Okay.
In, like, the 40s in France.
I want a shirt that says, is it solipsistic in here, or is it just me?
It's amazing to me how many people are, like, really bothered by the philosophy of solipsism. I'm like, no, that's the best!
Yeah, it means when I do bad things, it doesn't matter.
Yeah. That's why I'm a nihilist.
You're all hallucinations.
You're only offended because I'm allowing you to be offended.
You're just a really intricate fever dream.
And that's all life is.
Yeah, Fuller, good choice.
Hey, you said any road. It's that way.
So you picked the one we knew there was construction on because we came that way.
Yeah, but there could be plenty where that I didn't know there was construction.
Well, I suppose the devil you know is going to suck just as much as you know.
Exactly.
What time is it? Oh, 7:01. There it is.
Dinner time.
I gotta get going.
Turning left is gonna be fun.
Yes.
Getting it off will be super easy, because all you gotta do is unstrap it and then gun the truck in the van.
And then run!
And then it'll just... right off.
Stand about 50 feet back, lock your arms, stick them straight out.
I feel that's exactly how momentum works.
And then just stop it. Just drop your center of gravity really low. Like they do in kung fu movies.
So Fuller was a bad idea.
That guy's got a nice beard.
And I blame Lewis.
It's all your fault.
The interns are for.
How long have you been here?
A week?
Oh, a week? Turning left will be just fine. Everybody else is turning left, so.
Huh.
Didn't die. Super cool.
Didn't die. Had sex just fine.
Hey, didn't die what?
Didn't die, had sex.
There's a song, Kiss Me Deadly, that starts, I went to a party last Saturday night, I didn't get laid, I got in a fight. Oh, yes. It ain't no big thing.
Yes. Yep, that's green enough as well.
Really, if you think about it, it's autumn, and all the green are just turning into yellows. It's, you know, that's an autumn green right there, right?
That's a stretch.
It's an autumn green light.
Read it with a child at school. No. I will not.
They shut it down every, you know, not summer.
I didn't even know it existed.
Yep.
I'm from the suburbs. Where streets are named after plants. And everybody looks out the window at everybody else through the blinds.
I think I technically lived in Wyoming for a year.
You would know, it's really flat.
Yeah, not that one.
Oh.
The smaller Wyoming.
Okay.
Oh. We just passed the van, by the way.
they took Lafayette? That's an interesting choice. Let's take that thing down a really big hill, and then up a really big hill.
Oh, Batman.
Maybe they were bored.
This thing feels too secure. Let's just see how secure it really is.
There's a prerequisite element of danger that needs to be there for it to be a geek group event. And, you know, they've been here longer than we have. They know.
That's true. Almost everyone has been here longer than me.
That's true.
Except Theo. These two.
Except for Theo. Theo!
And Shoddy.
I still think Lucky would be a good nickname.
All I need is some slow, inspirational
music. I can
see you,
like, constantly in, like, some sort of, like, body cast, being, like, a mascot, you know? This is Lucky. He's going to explain to you about safety in the shop.
Oh, right. This whole intersection thing. I need to get to the right lane because everybody wants to turn on to that highway.
No, this is
except I can't because
you're in the correct lane.
This is the correct lane.
I know, but damn you, Tahoe!
Tahoe!
See, it's because you can't make it through because everybody wants to turn left.
Okay.
That's a red light.
That's another reason you can't make it through.
Nobody's going through because they're all turning. Red light. And that's where we all died. The phone footage stops.
And that's how they all died. I was thinking of that when the thing was stuck getting through the door. I was like, oh, I'm on the wrong side of this.
I thought the same thing. Like, we're all trapped in here now. This is the end.
That's when you see how burly Joe really is. When you tell him he's stuck in a room, punching my way out one of the walls.
Wouldn't be hard in that place if you don't mind getting a little mushroom, would you?
There's a couple of times we were going down the plywood to the ramps, where I was like, oh, I want to be on the side with the straps. I'm on the side with the rolls over me and I die.
It probably wouldn't roll over you.
No, I think what I was mostly worried about is that my foot was going to get under one of those casters and get snapped in half.
I'm sure when it pushed you over that your crotch would serve as a wheel chock.
Yeah, there you go. Only half crushed.
Ball chocks.
My hip would be a great wedge to stop it.
Absolutely.
Ugh. I'm going to say a word and everyone can shudder along with me. Broken pelvis.
That was two words.
Actually, it was just the word pelvis that was going to make you shudder.
Okay. Pelvis!
It's kind of a gross word.
It didn't really make me...
It's kind of a gross word. It
didn't make me shudder.
There's grosser words.
Yeah, it's kind of a
pelvis. I don't know. Pelvis is fine. It's actually kind of sonically...
Rupture.
All right.
Rupture is a kind of gross word.
I don't know. Rupture.
Maybe.
It's got the word sure in it. Like, ah, rupture.
It seems, no, yeah.
I'll take some rough. It's an
easygoing kind of word. Like, rough? Sure, yeah.
Yeah. You know.
You know, like when you're in bed, you're like, rough? Yeah, sure. I look a rough kind of night.
You want to rupture my what? Ah, sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, that's fine. I'm totally done with that. My girlfriend really hates the term moist.
Yeah, that's a girl thing.
Yeah. I've never met a girl who really enjoyed the word moist. Like, moist really did it for her.
Say moist again.
Ah, tell... It starts raining outside and she just loses her mind. Spring's her favorite season.
There's some good moist things. Cake?
Hmm. Pie? Water?
Mattresses? No, wait, that's not a good one.
You generally don't want a moist mattress.
Literally cannot see out the windshield. Literally driving blind.
That's how they all...
We're here! Turn left now!
Nope.
We're home!
You have to take my word for it. It's a shit.
And they returned home!
Oh, I was gonna make that.
And I would have taken full force of both of those cars.
Two cars at the same time, dude.
You ever had two cars at the same time, Johnny? And we're home. So we're back. And we have this now.
You beat us here?
Well, we also didn't have a giant computer.
40 minutes vlog, we got maybe 5 or 10 of the actual things.
Right.
And most of that was obscured by the sun.
Yeah, tell me about
it. And my shitty windshield.
The goddamn sun, I tell you. That's Doogie's. Hand it to
me. I still don't want it.
Hand it to Doogie.
Alright, so this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna strap it, push it forward to this corner so I can just pick it up with the forklift. Alright? No. Anyone understand?
Definitely.
Okay.
So, just a thing. We're trying to angle that one.
Maybe?
Yeah. I carefully take that small one. Actually, what I could do is I could split off here and meet you there. What a do. Also, apparently, I now know where Jillian is.
Yeah?
Yeah, she was just like... She just got out of her car with her back.
No. There's probably the whatnot's here.
I was like, Jillian!
Alright.
She's like, what do you have?
It's
it's a red light turning green, I'm trying to explain.
It's like, that's what the
on each side because
so you guys got a forklift really
tight. Yeah. What we gotta do is we're gonna push it.
No, I just don't want to.
This man of bats, get the forklift.
Is this a donation?
No, he bought this. Fuck.
Yes.
Okay. I mean, you don't have to be a
dick. We picked it up at the local Goodwill.
I don't have to be a dick, but I think it's a lot more fun. So the straps are now where we're pushing that thing.
Yes. Yep. That's where the rest of them were.
The mold is what we paid for.
Like once we clean it, it's like half as heavy.
Hey, record. Yep, no.
Not too much.
We probably want it close to the edge, right?
So we can get it all the way on the floor.
Batman's gonna move it closer to the edge.
You get my fashion. Should be able to just...
Yeah, it should.
No, okay.
Maybe.
Yeah, now that it's way off center.
That's right.
I got load shit.
Load shit up in this bitch.
Oh.
My SM just went up a little.
Really? That's good.
Because this weighs 7,000 pounds and the car only weighed one.
You guys weigh it?
Yes.
Yeah, we put it on the scale that was
we went to Padnos real quick. We put this along.
Padnos probably
No, Padnos is closed right now.
Oh.
I can see like Padnos like
I don't know.
Like drooling over this thing.
Not really. That's at least
$70
in scrap.
That's a thing you can actually do with good Padnos.
Hey, instead of standing around, why don't you start unloading the van?
Oh yeah, that will make
it. Just fuck you, that's one.
I'm gonna park the trailer.
Hey, actually, Casey, park the trailer back to there enough. That'd probably work.
Uh-oh. Come on. Up. Oh, there we go. That was all.
I'm working on it.
Get right upstairs. I just need to get Casey a key to the van.
Yeah, this needs to go in Studio A, by the way.
Yeah, funny.
That's a fuck you, Zoe.
I don't even think, even if we were to split it in half, because it's two giant aluminum boxes. You can see the seam right in the middle. Even if we were to split it in half, it still wouldn't fit with a tiny ass door.
Yeah, it's a seam.
This is...
Isn't it pretty?
Kinda.
It's
corroded to hell.
You know what's great? The capacitors. Jerry. The capacitors. Cornell Dublier.
Well, we can get more. We can get this thing refurbished.
Just get the same.
Get capacitors. It up and running.
They're like, oh yeah, let me go check. Yeah, there they are.
I forgot there was covered in that. I was like, oh.
It's a little bit of mold, a little bit of rust, a little bit of dust, and there's probably a few mice still in there.
Has anyone found any money in the parking lot today? Like, just a bill?
No.
Have the...
Find it like this.
Okay.
Just some paper money, I guess.
Nope.
Fragrance. I don't think I have...
That's... Yeah. That's...
Oh yeah. I went on the, survey.
You've been in it?
Yeah. I was in there yesterday.
I accept.
I don't know what I'm getting.
The guy was bumping around in there and Chris was like,
I'm not liking the situation. We don't see the guy, we just hear random knocking in the house. Like a struggle.
Yes. All right, plug it in.
I think I actually saw the mic that's powered.
Yeah, it's over there. There's a little conduit that pops out.
Have you
All right, everybody, time to make the bomb.
Okay, I need to drink more.
And I think there's what, an off-on switch and one button?
I
found more
buttons. Two buttons.
There's a whole bunch of buttons.
There's a bunch of these.
There's a whole gang of buttons. And spinny gears. We need to hire a whole team of interns just to clean this thing. Take it all apart. Clean all the gears.
Intern?
I'm an audio intern.
You're still an intern?
He's new. He's new. He can do it.
So?
He can do it by himself.
Need some Clorox.
Oh, we got Simple Green left, don't we?
Simple Green won't kill the mold.
It has to be bleach.
Yeah.
You are all over the place.
Trust me,
camera.
Brushing it off is going to do any help.
I know.
By the time you get home, they're going to be covering a green edit vlog tonight, along with all of the viewers.
Should have been there for the car ride back.
Where is Chris?
Vlogged the whole thing. He said he had to be in town for something. I don't know. He left before we even had this finished being loaded on the truck.
He's like, I'm done.
Or trailer. He just said,